following is a special presentation of ESPN College Football on ABC.
Please take your seats, everybody. The curtain is about to go up. It's LSU and Oregon. The Ducks quarterback Darren Thomas is back, but with a brand new number. LSU's Ballyhoo Tigers will hand the ball to senior quarterback Jared Lee. The race to New Orleans in the BCS Championship is about to begin. Welcome to Cowboys Classic presented by Southwest Airlines. It's part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week. You are looking live at Cowboys Stadium in Arlington, Texas, where a sellout crowd of over 80,000 has arrived for the most anticipated season opener in years. It's the number 3 Oregon Ducks against the number 4 LSU Tigers. It's a high-stakes battle with a pot of gold at the end of the BCS rainbow. Welcome, everybody, and good evening with Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brent Musburger. When last we left you, Auburn beating Oregon for a national championship. The Tigers struggled mightily today before beating Utah State. But Herbie, guess who's back on the big stage?
That's
the
right.
Oregon Ducks.
Well, the Oregon Ducks and Chip Kelly. Another opportunity, really, for this program to try to gain some more national credibility. It starts with LaMichael James, of course, a Heisman Trophy frontrunner. Last year, he won the Doak Walker, led the nation in rushing. But I think Darren Thomas, much like the national championship, when the running game wasn't there, Darren Thomas's ability to not only run but throw will be a key tonight. We know that he has the athletic ability to pull it out if you dominate the line of scrimmage and try to worry about James and Barner, but his ability to throw, I think, was key in the national championship and keeping the Ducks in that game. And again, against another big SEC defensive line, Thomas will have to prove that he can throw the ball.
And Herbie, I'm sure that everybody's aware LSU is without quarterback Jordan Jefferson, was suspended indefinitely. But you're telling me now that Jared Lee brings a lot of experience into this game.
He really does. I mean, this is his 10th career start. His last start was back in 2008 when he was a redshirt freshman and when he didn't have a lot of success. But last year, in a backup role to Jordan Jefferson, he did do well with the Swamp stepping in and making a play late to secure that victory against Alabama. Yeah, Alabama, fifth in the nation. In that game, when the pressure is on, he delivers and converts a big fourth down and allowed his football team to go on to win the game. He's dropped 20 pounds. He's made a commitment, even as a backup. And now the door is open. It's his chance to show his teammates he's got what it takes to get it done.
Herbie, do you think either of these teams will be arrested for speeding here tonight?
I'm telling you, Brent, we're going to watch a lot of great games this year. This game tonight will have the most speed on both sides of the field of any game we call all year. There's speed everywhere with Oregon and LSU.
All right, it's Oregon. LSU about to begin here at Cowboys Stadium in Arlington, Texas.
John Saunders and Jesse Palmer is next after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Most headroom per dollar of any car in America. The all-new Nissan Versa sedan from $10,990. Innovation upsized. Innovation for all.
I will be changing my name to Meta World Peace. However, for the next couple months, you can just call me Dancing with the Stars Champion.
The Lakers' Ron Artest joins Dancing with the Stars live premiere Monday, September 19th on ABC.
There's luxury that lulls. And there's luxury that thrills. Infiniti, inspired performance.
Visit the Infiniti Limited Engagement Summer Event. Our inventory selection is outstanding. The best offers of the season are now available. Lease an Infiniti G25 sedan for $319 per month or get 1.9% APR on all 2011 models.
We caught a glimpse of you. We caught a glimpse of you. And the color of your mind. Oh, 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 oh. We caught a glimpse of you.
Coca-Cola glasses are at McDonald's. One free with every large extra value meal, like the one-of-a-kind Big Mac. The simple joy of seeing things in a whole new light.
Nissan's bottom line sales event has been extended. With better availability than Honda or Toyota, you save. Get an additional $500 holiday bonus cash on popular models like Altima, $179 plus bonus cash. Visit ChooseNissan.com. Test drive at your local Nissan dealer today. More cars, bonus cash, more savings. Hurry, and September 5th.
Time and temperature from TD Bank.
The Nissan Pre-Game Show. Nissan, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy.
Welcome to our studios here at ABC. John Saunders alongside of Jesse Palmer. What a way to kick off the season. Number 4 against number 5 in a compelling matchup in this one. But first, let's get to the team that finished off number 1 just a year ago. That was Auburn. They struggled today. Michael Dyer bailed them out late.
Auburn's defense gave up 227 rushing yards. If they're going to compete inside the SEC West, they must get better on that side of the football.
Alabama, could they contend for a national championship this year? Trent Richardson finds a hole, breaks through. He's one of the best in the country.
Richardson had 3 touchdown runs, but both Alabama quarterbacks combined for 4 interceptions. They're going on the road for a tough game next week at Penn State.
Andrew Luck, Heisman Trophy favorite, and here's why. Finds Zach Ertz in the corner of the end zone.
Stanford has the best group of tight ends in the country. Andrew Luck, efficient as always, and he gets David Shaw a win in his debut as head coach at Stanford.
It rained in the Midwest. Notre Dame and South Florida were delayed for about 2 hours. They finally called the Western Michigan-Michigan game. Michigan gets the win. And things in the SEC East may be a bit different. Florida blowing out their squad, and South Carolina losing to East Carolina. Who do you like in our game tonight?
Well, I like LSU in our game tonight. I think that they'll be able to establish the run on offense. I think Jarrett Lee at quarterback will be able to manage this game, limit mistakes. On the flip side, their physical defense, I think, will keep Oregon one-dimensional. I think they'll limit the explosive plays by running backs LaMichael James and Kenyon Barner.
We, of course, will see at halftime. Right now, let's join Brent Musburger.
All right, John, and here come the Ducks. This has been the Nissan Pregame Show. Kickoff is coming up live from Arlington, Texas. And now a look inside Nissan's Heisman House.
Back there, rookie.
Hey, hi.
Uh-oh, rookie's not gonna get a seat.
Game time.
What I want.
I said, don't stop, don't stop, don't stop talking to me.
The most
most legroom per dollar of any car in America. The all-new Nissan Versa sedan from $10,990. Innovation upsize. Innovation for all.
USA Prime Credit, tell Peggy your problem.
Hey, Peggy, I got five dadgum charges here for Miss Priss's Cat Emporium.
Dadgum?
Now, Peggy, tell me, do I sound like a man who'd have five dadgum charges at a Miss Priss's Cat Emporium?
You break up. Call back next week.
I'm not too old to find you, son.
Want better customer service? Switch to Discover. Ranked number one in customer loyalty. It pays to Discover.
This is Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week. Saturday Night Football on ABC. Brought to you by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's.
Oregon fans are outnumbered here tonight, and here's the reason why. From Eugene to Arlington, it is over 2,000 miles. Catch a jet. But from Baton Rouge, 465 miles to drive on over. So Tiger coach Les Miles down below with the third member of our team. Let's go to Aaron Andrews. Aaron.
Brent, thanks so much. Forget about the players' nerves. What just happened to you when you ran out of the tunnel? Where were you going?
They were so hot on my trail. If I would have stayed in their path, I'd ended up underneath them, I promise you. They wanted out of the tunnel.
I think you got a little confused. Hey, let me ask you about your quarterback, Jarrett Lee. Starting for the first time since 09, what was the last piece of advice you gave him before he ran out?
Just play the plays that we call, enjoy himself. He's earned the right. Enjoy the day.
You too.
See ya.
Brent, back up to you.
All right. Les won the flip. He deferred. Oregon will get the ball to start the game. There's Chip Kelly. The first wrinkle here today, LaMichael James is back deep with Kenyon Barner back to return this kickoff. Here's your Heisman Trophy candidate from Eugene. So we have a wonderful scene here tonight. The Duck is certainly ready. Let's settle back and enjoy the opening kickoff. Big 12 conference officials, Scott Novak's our referee.
During the return, holding, receiving team number 96, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Well, here comes the quarterback, Darren Thomas. And a year ago, he was wearing number one, Herbie, and here he is in his high school number out of Houston, number five.
Yeah, back in his home state. And remember the last time we saw the Ducks, they were unable to run the football, and they relied on his ability to throw. They need to get him settled into this game tonight and get him in the rhythm early.
And a throw on first down. LaMichael James on the sideline, and he's out to about the 18-yard line.
When it comes to tempo, you know, big part of what Oregon wants to do, and the umpire's going to have to be ready. This is a crew out of the Big 12. They will need to get the tempo going. A big part of that is wearing LSU down throughout the game.
At the mesh point, it's James going for the first down. Can he get it? Yes. Muscles for it. And another penalty flag down at the 35-yard line, thrown in the LSU secondary.
Like a potential chop block there by Josh Huff. Trying to pick up a block. These receivers are very aggressive with their blocking.
Personal foul. Clipping on the offense, number one. Half the distance of the goal.
Chip getting an explanation from the field judge. We take a look at some of the fellows who are going to make an impact here tonight.
Well, we talked a lot about Darren Thomas, but he's going to need help. And LaMichael James and Kenyon Barner both in the backfield, and both can come out and catch the football. You already saw LaMichael make a play. And 2-A on the outside. Jeff Mayo is no longer here for the Ducks, and 2-A has to be the leader on the outside.
They have to get to the 23-yard line for a first down. Thomas to try and throw for it. He is well short. Out of bounds. And Barner was the receiver. And there's another piece of yellow down on the field as Tyron Matthew was the defender. And he's a dandy in that LSU secondary.
Challenges of playing that first
leg
game.
Leg whip on the offense.
Gets the quality opponent. Have what, four after plays and three goal. Penalties?
Second down.
Had one on the opening kickoff. Yeah. Had a couple more now. In the stage fright here. Opening night jitters.
Everybody anxious to see this Oregon retooled offensive line. A lot of new faces, including a freshman at center in Grasso, against his strength of LSU, which of course the depth and speed and talent of their defensive line.
So with that penalty, the ball comes back near the 5-yard line, and they've still got to get to the 23. Dangerous spot here on second down for Thomas and the Ducks. The intended target that time, and that will bring up a huge third down. And the Ducks are back on their heels here early.
Yeah, and you're not used to seeing Chip Kelly's offense going in the other direction. And when they get into second and third and long, that's obviously exactly what LSU wants to see. And John Chavis will bring in six defensive backs to match up the speed with the Ducks on the perimeter.
Very dangerous for Thomas from his end zone. Hit on the release, incomplete. Ducks are forced to punt.
This is the challenge against LSU. Kiki Mingo will come unblocked. Lack of communication. You have some new faces up front. The crowd is into this game. The defense is taking advantage of the emotion, and a miscommunication forces on a long third down Darren Thomas to throw that football before he was ready.
LSU can wind up a great field position. Matthew, the return man, standing on the Oregon 45-yard line. And this is a short punt. Excellent field position coming up. Does take an Oregon hop. Field near midfield. Here comes Matthews. Matthews tries to get the sideline. He's out of bounds across the 40-yard line. Now it'll be Jarrett Lee. But, Herbie, the one negative that I see about him is that in his career he's thrown as many interceptions as touchdowns.
Yeah, and he's made some changes. Most of those interceptions came in his freshman year, where he threw actually seven pick sixes as a freshman. The year after LSU won the national championship, he's been in a backup role the last couple years. What I love is he committed to lose the weight in the offseason, knowing he more than likely would be a backup. All of a sudden there's the issue with Jordan Jefferson, and he finds himself in this huddle as a starting quarterback.
End zone 39 yards away. Here comes that running game. And the last time this young man, Ware, found this field, he gained over 100 yards against Texas A&M in the Cotton Bowl.
And Spencer Ware has great power, a lot of physical ability. He's about 225 pounds. You're going to see him a lot tonight, number 11. Also, Odell Beckham, he's a true freshman. They think he could really help out with the loss of Russell Shepard. And, of course, Reuben Randall on the outside needs to get vertical tonight against the Ducks if they overcommit to running the football by LSU.
Veteran offensive line. And here comes Ware again to daylight across the 30 for a first down on their first series. Michael Clay with the tackle.
This is what LSU feels they can do against the undersized Oregon front seven. They feel that that veteran line, Brent, that you talked about, can not only win the battle up front, but they can get to that second level and get into the face of the linebackers. And if you give Spencer Ware enough room, he can get downfield in a hurry. And just a couple plays in, Jarrett Lee looks very, very comfortable because of that big offensive line in this running game.
Sticking on the ground with Ware. He pounds to the 25. Ball goes down. Ball's loose. LSU jumped in on top of it. That ball came free. Oregon signaling that they've got it. It was bouncing on the turf. They'll try to unpile the big fellas down there. LSU keeps it. That's a big save down there.
It's something that Spencer Ware, who was a high school quarterback, needs to be prepared for. And that ball definitely came out. And boy, it's right there. And Mitchell, this corner, dives on it. And then it's a free-for-all. LSU very fortunate to get back on that football. It looked like the linebacker, Michael Clay, might have jarred that football loose.
And Ware might have gone back and recovered it, Herbie, as we looked at the end of that replay. Regardless, it's a second down and 10 here for LSU. And now Alfred Blue comes in as the running back, and LSU shows a power eye. And this is Blue's first carry. So it'll be third and long coming up as Stuckey is in there. And so pretty good defensive series here in Oregon against this offensive line. Focus on the man in the middle, Herbie. Lonergan is a great veteran, his 16th start here.
Yeah, very athletic, intelligent, like most centers are, has to make most of the calls. You know, just watching this early, LSU has a size advantage up front. They're going to keep committing to running the ball. Oregon starts to cheat those safeties up. LSU will definitely play action and try to get behind them. This is a big third down.
Could be the first pass of the game for Lee. Checks over to the sideline to see what they want to do from the gun. And across the 20 for the first down. Slips. Comes back with his footing. Incomplete. And it is fourth down. And, of course, LSU is without their great kicker of many years, who is not here. He moved on, graduated, and they always rely on this kicking game. When you're a Les Miles, Jasper was just one of the best in SEC history. And so now they will come out, and this is Drew Alema. He has taken over, and that number 30, of course, is passed on to the kicker. This is a 44-yarder to give the Tigers the lead. Looks good. LSU settles for a field goal. So if you're an Oregon fan, you can say, hey, that could have been a touchdown. But they'll need a ton of number 21 to get back in this one tonight. We'll be right back.
Southwest makes the call.
Swipe credit card.
What? You gotta be kidding me. I am absolutely not paying this fee.
Please swipe
this
credit card.
Hey, let's keep it above the wallet.
Unbelievable.
I've got Ruffin. The passenger's wallet.
You okay, Si? Yeah,
thanks, Ruff.
Looks like they hit you with the fee pretty hard.
Sure did. Good call,
Please
Ruff.
Swipe credit card.
Look, see?
That's it. You're gone.
Bags fly free. Southwest Airlines. It's the right call.
Humans have 3,000 thoughts a day. The engine of the Buick Regal Turbo has 125 million thoughts a second. Each one designed to optimize engine performance, giving you 220 horsepower and up to 32 highway MPG. The 2011 Regal Turbo. During the Buick Summer Event, lease this Regal Turbo for $259 per month.
This is The Network, a network of possibilities.
Excuse me, my grandfather was born in this village.
In here, everyone speaks the same language. In here, forklifts drive themselves. In here, friends leave you messages written in the air. It's the AT&T network, and what's possible in here is almost impossible to say.
I'm a raccoon, and this time in your attic has been the best week of my raccoon life. I'm digging, I'm nesting in this fluffy stuff. I've already had like four babies. I'm the smartest raccoon I know. And if you got your home insurance where you got your 15-minute car insurance, you could be paying for this yourself. So get Allstate. You could save money and be better protected from mayhem, like me.
Dollar for dollar, nobody protects you from mayhem like Allstate agents.
Prepare yourself for the ultimate fantasy team.
Hello, Angels.
ABC's Charlie's Angels, series premiere Thursday, September 22nd.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
We welcome you back to Arlington, Texas. You knew the Duck was going to travel at 2,000. Plus miles. He'd be here tonight for this one. This is Barner again, this time from the 10-yard line. Excellent return, and the key thing is I don't see a
penalty flag on this one.
Herbie, we've got a holiday weekend Monday night college game, ACC battle. Miami taking on Maryland. What's your thoughts about that one?
Well, you have two new head coaches, and Al Golden and Randy Edsall taking over. Of course, all the suspensions for Miami, the distractions off the field. Golden, I think, will have his team focused. Stephen Moore steps in at quarterback for Ja'Cory Harris. And Danny O'Brien, sophomore year after a great year as a freshman for the Terps. Be a good one.
Again on first down, Herbie, and a little bit high on a crossing pattern. Tuane coming across, and it'll be second down and 10 as a result of that.
And even with an incompletion, they're going to go hurry up. Very important to get the tempo established here for Chip Kelly in this offense.
Mesh point. James looking for daylight in that big defensive front. Jumps on it. Doesn't get much. It's going to put you in third and long.
Always think about these teams in these first games getting ready for Oregon. They've had 7 or 8 months to prepare for the tempo. It's very different from having just a week to get ready. And this early in this game, LSU getting lined up and ready for this tempo of Darren Thomas.
They stack the front. Thomas goes down the middle. Incomplete. And they are forced to punt. Had a crack at it. That would have been a first down if they had made the completion.
Darren Thomas right now, I think, is feeling some of the pressure from LSU. It's the second, third, and long that he's had to deal with in two possessions. Ball is behind Vaughn. He had enough time to be able to execute, but I just don't think right now Darren Thomas has been able to settle in and get comfortable into the flow of this game.
Herbie Mathieu is back on the field to return this, and Jackson Rice standing on the Ducks 20. First punt not too good. This one a lot better. And it's Rob Mathieu signaling for the fair catch, and he goes down around the 15-yard line. So much better field position if you're an Oregon fan. And LSU will have to go the distance, leading it by a field goal.
With available features like the Harman Kardon 5.1 matrix surround system, 10 gigs of music storage, 384 watts of power, 11 speakers, and 3 months of satellite radio. The best entertainment system in your house won't always be in your house. The 2011 LaCrosse from Buick.
Looking for life insurance can feel like a jungle of ifs. To steer clear of the confusion, go to MetLife.com. Get straight answers like how much you need and how much it costs, so you can make the best decision for your family. Go to MetLife.com today.
Human boxing is dead. Now it's a whole different game.
Give me a main event.
Winner takes all.
No!
This is my last shot.
Shadow function.
I've never seen anything like it.
Watch me.
I'm ready to fight.
Real Steel, rated PG-13.
When you're looking for a twist, crack open a Bud Light Lime.
It's a fraction of the whole, but it's hard to control.
The great taste of Bud Light with a twist. Bud Light Lime. All the refreshment of Bud Light with a splash of 100% natural lime flavor. Bud Light Lime. It's Bud Light with a twist.
Saturday Night Football on ABC. Presented by Southwest Airlines. Find our fares online only at southwest.com. The Chevy Model Year Wrap-Up. Get in on our greatest model year yet. And Chick-fil-A, we didn't invent the chicken, just the chicken sandwich.
The house of Jerry Bell. Hey, Herbie, look who's been duck hunting. Mike Tiger.
Mike is ready.
Where is back on first down there, running nowhere. struggled to get back line of scrimmage. Herbie, during that break, you should pass along to the audience what you were saying about the LSU passing game. It's important.
Well, it is very, very important because I'm sensing that Oregon's starting to commit to stopping this run game. And one thing that's been lacking in LSU's attack the last 2 years is the vertical passing game. But we talked to them this week, and they said, you know what, we're going to pound them, but we also know we're going to have to try to get the ball thrown behind them because they're going to start to stack the line of scrimmage, and we're going to have that ability to throw.
Well, there's a swing pass on second and long. They get it to Beckham. Now, there is a young man whose mother, Herbie, you were telling, his mother was an All-American track runner at LSU. Pops was a running back at one time.
Right. Yeah, he was. I mean, think about that gene pool. Not very bad, right? Your mom's an All-American at LSU running track. Dad played football at LSU. They think he could fill the void with Russell Shepard now out. 33 is definitely a guy to keep an eye on if they can get the ball to him in space. Big third down here for this Oregon defense.
And Alfred Blue comes into pass protect on this third and long for LSU. Monaghan checks the front. They've identified the Mike linebacker. Snaps it off short of the first down. Short of the first down by a couple of yards. And in that situation, in third down, you've got to get that receiver to that marker. And that was Beckham again.
And that's part of being a true freshman. I think he slipped at the end of his break here trying to get back to the football. And he's right at the line, or right at the line where he needed to get the first down. And that's why you want to see him go just a little bit further to give, in case you do slip out of that break, you're at least beyond the first down marker. But a big stop for Oregon.
Here's where the Ducks are going to miss Cliff Harris. Suspended for this game, starting defensive back. Returned, I believe, 4 punts for touchdowns a year ago. Barner will replace him. Now, he's an outstanding return man. And Brad Wing, the Australian, is back to punt. And there's a whistle. Before the snap.
A delay.
And a delay of game that cost Wing
offense.
5 yards. A little bit of a costly mistake. You're going to take a 5 if you're down on the other side of the field trying to give yourself more punting room, but not here.
And field position has been so big for LSU and favoring them, and I think part of the momentum with this home crowd essentially here in Dallas and or in Arlington, and the way this game has started, anything that Oregon can do to kind of weather the storm and tilt the field back to their advantage is big.
The Ducks thought that LSU might want to fake that last one. Now they've sent in their special team personnel, and this will go out near midfield. Not a particularly good punt for LSU, and the Ducks are going to have their best field position of the night when you come back. Can Darren Thomas and LaMichael James light it up? We'll find out.
It's time to make our floor look better and feel softer. How about we start with the guaranteed low price on the carpet, the pad, and installation? Let's get peace of mind for a lifetime. It all adds up to better carpet at a better price. And a great-looking room transformed. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Get 10% off or 24-month special financing on your first purchase of $599 or more when you open a new Home Depot credit card account.
So, what do you think?
I'm not crazy about these light fixtures. What's next?
607 Franklin Street. Sea bass. I like it.
Yeah, I love the kitchen.
The EPA estimated 42 MPG highway Chevy Cruze Eco. Perfect for finding your way home.
Lose the grime. Get touch-up clean hair with Axe Shampoo and get some hair action.
Our 99-cent chicken flatbread sandwiches, now in 2 bold flavors, only at Taco Bell.
ABC's Charlie's Angels premieres Thursday, September 22nd at 8, 7 Central.
And the home of the Texas Rangers off there to the right. So a World Series and a Super Bowl in the house at Jerryville, which is where we are. LSU leading Oregon. The Ducks are with their best field position of the night. That aerial coverage provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned making tires for superior performance inspires what they roll into yours. So here we go on first down at the mesh point is LaMichael. He's down to about the 46. You're predicting that Oregon's going to get the offense going now.
Well, they finally have good field position, and it's the first successful first down play that they've had in their three series. They at least moved the ball forward, and when Oregon doesn't have success on first and 10, it's disaster for the offense.
Now on second down, wide open. Near the first down marker over there is DeAnthony Thomas, the young sensational player for Crenshaw High School, touching the ball for the first time here tonight. He figures prominently in the Ducks' plan.
He and Josh Huff and Kenyon Barner have to be big tonight, one-on-one in the pass game.
And LaMichael for a tough first down against that SEC front. The chains will move now, and they're across the 40.
Watch the little wiggle here by James. I mean, his man is beaten. The freshman center that time, Brasu, gets pushed right back into the backfield by Brockers, but the vision that time and a quickness and acceleration got the first down by James.
James again, and nothing moving in the middle when you go up against the SEC. You know, Herbie, when you look around the NFL at the rosters, and Chip Kelly knows this as well as anybody, you are up against premier defensive linemen from LSU. Les Miles has put more in the NFL over the last 6 or 7 years than anybody in the SEC. I mean, those NFL rosters are sprinkled with defensive linemen from LSU.
Without a doubt. And the linebackers also, so far, have been freed up to be able to make plays against James.
There's that inside pitch to LaMichael. He's got some daylight. Busts across for a first down. Beautifully executed by Darren Thomas.
That is a great recognition and a great call from the sideline. They saw Kiki Mingo, number 49, upfield. See him to the right, and he's going to get upfield. Because he gets upfield so quickly, it sets up perfectly the shovel pass underneath the speed off the edge by LSU. Mingo took himself out of the play, and it allowed James to get upfield quickly for that first down.
And this is the most impressive offensive drive of the night so far. Receiver should have had it. Got right through the hands of Carson.
You're right. That's a play you have got to make. And it's the second time we've seen them on first and 10 throw the ball out of the backfield to the right. One time to James, which was called back. First play of the game. And then there to Carson. And, of course, now we got a great white shark getting some air there. Shark
that's,
week.
That's Paul Westhead. That means go fast, fast, and faster. That was the up-tempo basketball coach. Second down and 10. That's how they signal in formations and sometimes plays. Now Barner in the game gets the carry and he's eaten alive. He couldn't get the corner trying to turn it. And Matthew up to make the play.
Well, again, a lot like Auburn, this is the SEC. You cannot get to the sideline. You can't get to the corner against this defense. You have got to be able to find vertical seams upfield north and south. If you try to bounce things, even LaMichael James or Kenyon Barner against LSU's defense, they just have too much speed for that.
Paulson lines up in the backfield on this big third down. They'll slide him out. Thomas to the middle, caught at the 15-yard line. A huge first down pass to Justin Hoffman. He's a junior from Eugene.
Well, I think it's a miscommunication that time by Hoffman coming right to the middle. 2-and-8 also breaks it off to the middle. They almost collided, but Hoffman's able to secure the football for the first down.
Big 14-yard gain on that third down. Now it's first and 10 at the LSU 15.
It's the first time we've seen Oregon be Oregon, and LSU's defense now a little bit more back on their heels.
Play clock inside of 10 seconds. Under pressure, tries to get it outside and nothing doing because Simon made a fine play right there. Simon was all over the receiver, Josh Huff.
We talked so much about this LSU defensive line, but you know they lost Patrick Peterson, and you think, wow, the secondary might be taking a step back with a guy who was picked in the top 10 of the NFL draft. This secondary, as a two deep, might be as good as anything, not only in the SEC, but anything you might see in the entire country.
A second and long. Checking back over the sideline.
See Matthew at the bottom, number 7. He's a playmaker for the LSU defense. He looks like he may be coming off the edge.
Inside of 10 now, the play clock. Handing off. Power run toward the 10-yard line, so they pick up a few yards. They make third down manageable here with LaMichael James back on the field.
What LSU is doing with either a defensive back or an outside linebacker is they're rushing upfield. Oregon's adjustment to that has been to go underneath it with the run game.
Quick throw for that screen and incomplete. So Oregon can't hang on to the ball a little bit. That was Murphy on the outside that time, and you would think here comes Rob Beard, the very reliable field goal specialist, the junior from Fullerton, California. He kicked a 42-yarder last year at Tennessee when Oregon went in and won in Knoxville. 10 of 13 overall a year ago, 77%. This is a 29-yarder for the tie. From the right hash. Slipped it through. Inside of 4 minutes in the first quarter, Oregon and LSU are tied.
The SEC Digital Network. 8 supercharged channels that put the fan experience into internet overdrive. Find schedules, stats, and more. Download full games and videos on demand. Hear from league insiders. Explore SEC mobile apps. See the new SEC Smart TV. Get gear at the online store. See hometown heroes in action. And plug in live to Game Day Central. Get it all at secdigitalnetwork.com.
Pac-12 football. The story of raw talent and radical rivalries. It's a story that inspires us again, again, and again. Pac-12, the Conference of Champions.
We welcome you back to the Cowboys Classic with Kurt Herbstreit, Aaron Andrews. I'm Brett Musburger. LSU kicked the field goal first, and now the Ducks have tied them. So Oregon will kick off for the first time here tonight. And it is LSU which has to be a little bit concerned about the lack of offense here so far. Claiborne is back deep along with Brooks. That's Claiborne right there. Field it from the 8-yard line. He'll try to get the sideline and does for a good return out to about the 28. Well, let's get an update, and here's Robert Flores in our studio. Robert.
All right, Brent Taco Bell studio update. Game on ESPN between number 5 Boise State and number 19 Georgia. The Bulldogs uniforms currently blowing up Twitter. Here's Brandon Boykin blowing up the Boise State off defense. 80-yard touchdown. Georgia out on top, 7-0, first quarter.
And here, Robert, we're deadlocked at 3. LSU trying to generate offense. They've had only 21 total yards. They've had good field position. Jarrett Lee with a power eye.
8 men up close to the line of scrimmage.
Here's Ware on a toss play. Picked up about 3 yards.
Greg Stadrawa, the offensive coordinator for LSU, saying, you know, the last couple years, a lot of times we've blocked things pretty well as an offense, but there's 9 guys up at the line of scrimmage because defenses haven't respected our vertical passing game. And he said, we are committed, even with a new quarterback and a lot of new receivers. There he is off to the left there in the white jacket. He said, we're committed to throwing it downfield if defenses are going to try to load up the line of scrimmage this year against us.
Second down and long. Play action. Tries to get deep middle, and he's got it. And the ball's put down, and they're waving it off. it looked like he had a big gain in the hands of Claymore, but he couldn't hang on.
What a big hit that time by Eddie Pleasant, who's become one of the leaders of this defense, and he separates him. That is really, really close to being a fumble. But Eddie Pleasant, in position, lowers the boom that time on Clement. Sets LSU here for a big third down, but there's the vertical passing game. There they are trying to keep that secondary honest instead of loading up the line of scrimmage.
Needing 7 yards here. Keep this drive going. It's going to be close. He's got it. Battles for the first down. Beautiful run by Spencer Ware after the catch. Outstanding all-around athlete. Not only a good running back, but a good receiver out of the backfield.
How about the effort here by Ware? I mean, right there, I don't think he has it. But that second, third, and even fourth effort that time by Spencer Ware gets it. You can see where he needs to get. He's not there yet, but that effort right there got across for the first down. Powerful young man.
Michael Ford is now on the field as Ware goes to the sideline. And they'll use the fullback. They did not surprise the middle of the defensive front of Oregon. Not a big gain on first down. You would think at some point, with the way Jarrett Lee has thrown his last two passes, that they would start pitching it on first down.
Well, that's the time. If you're going to try to go downfield, the time to do it is first and 10. You're not going to wait the second or third down. You've got to take your chances on first and 10. And if you've watched Oregon, that's where they're putting a lot of guys and committing a lot of guys to the line of scrimmage.
On the right side of that line,
ball
coming across,
on the offense,
Will Blackwell may have jumped.
5 yard penalty, second down.
Now Mike's trying to get, he's trying to get over there. He wants to check the Georgia Boise State game for just a minute and we'll see if that remote can get that. I'll come back to my Tigers.
How many people can relate to Mike today? First Saturday, college football season, kicked back, got your remote, got your chores done, ready to watch some football all day, all night.
Costly 5 yards. Second down and long for the Tigers. Straight back. Hit on the release. One on one, incomplete. High in the air went Boone, and he couldn't hang on. Had a shot at it. Gilden with coverage for the Ducks.
I'll tell you, Gilden did a good job at the last moment of getting his hand up to be able to get the ball away, but the pressure got there, and it forced Jarrett Lee to throw the ball off his back foot. Stuckey does a good job, and because he throws it off the back foot, he underthrows his receiver, and that's what allowed Gilden to come back and eventually find the football and knock it away.
Nick Aliotti dialing up some pressure here, and he's got LSU in third and long. It's an impressive start for a defense that had to replace a lot. Bad snap. Free ball. Ware goes for it. And he's down. Ball still loose. Still free. Did the Ducks finally get it? Yes, they did. Jarrett Lee wanted to call timeout. Walked away from it. And the veteran Lonergan snapped it anyway. And the scrum was on. And the Ducks have come up with a huge turnover. Locombo recovered the fumble for Oregon, and Jarrett Lee is explaining to Les what went wrong. And there's Lonergan over there with the coach.
And Jarrett Lee looked like not so much the timeout, but maybe making an adjustment to the protection. He sees the blitz, and he's pointing over there, and the center decides to snap the ball. Lonergan on his own. The ball is free. Oregon, the entire defense going after it, and they catch a break here and get great field position.
Great time to strike after a turnover. All of you know it. Fires a slant, and they get it to about the 13-yard line on first down, and that makes second and third so manageable for him. 2-and-A, the receiver.
They motioned James to the left. It cleared the linebackers out and came back to 2-and-A to the right.
Thomas keeps it in the air. Incomplete. Didn't want to chance an interception. There was good coverage on the outside. 2-and-A was the receiver again, and Josh Huff was also working in that area. Now you third down, but you've got only 3 yards here. One of the things we note tonight with Chip Kelly, he has gone to the pass much earlier than he did against Auburn in that national championship game last January. He stuck with the run throughout much of that game. Here, he's keeping the ball in the air. Incomplete on the slant. Huff, the intended target.
We kind of anticipated him having to do that against this LSU front. The challenge, Brent, is you're breaking in some new receivers, and you're going up against a very physical LSU defensive secondary, and they are locking up those Oregon wide receivers, and they're not getting any separation at all. So it's easy to look at Thomas and say, why isn't he completing enough passes? He's 7 of 15. But the LSU defensive backs have locked up these Oregon receivers.
Herbie, you told me yesterday you thought this could be a low-scoring game, and here is Beard with a 31-yarder. And Oregon goes up. But I'm just sort of curious, when you said it to me, you know, we've got this high-powered offense certainly on Oregon's part. You thought maybe for a time that LSU might have to match points. But you said right away you thought, well, we could be in for a low-scoring game here tonight.
Yeah, I really thought that, because I have a lot of respect for LSU and John Chavis. And as good as Oregon is on offense, we know how good and how athletic LSU can be. And I'll tell you, Nick Galeotti, I don't know if enough people appreciate the job that he does for Oregon. When you think of Oregon nationally, just always about the offense and Chip Kelly. But Nick Galeotti's the guy that kept them in the national championship and slowed down Cam Newton and kept him within striking distance. And they lost a ton off of that defense from a year ago, most especially Casey Matthews and Spencer Paysinger and Kenny Rowe. And there's Nick Galeotti. He's retooled this defense. And early in the game, they have really made a commitment to the line of scrimmage. And they're basically saying this: if you're going to beat us, Jarrett Lee is going to have to beat us by throwing the football, because we are going to stack the line of scrimmage and make Jarrett Lee show us he can throw the ball.
Is there a chance we're going to see Mettenberger in this game, the JC transfer? What do you think?
I would be shocked if we did. He's got great physical tools, but understanding the scheme and understanding the defenses right now, he's just not quite there. So I think Jarrett Lee is going to have to get it done.
That's number 8 right there. Had a cup of coffee at Georgia, went to junior college, and transferred into LSU. He brings great size, 6'5", sophomore out of the state of Georgia. Beard's kickoff in the end zone, and it'll come out on the 20. Let us go quickly to Robert Flores for another update. Robert.
All right, Brent, another SEC school in trouble. Earlier it was Auburn. Tonight it's South Carolina. After crawling within 3, East Carolina's Dominic Davis finds Joe Womack, and the Pirates are leading on the road in Columbia 24-14 at the half. Meantime, South Florida leading Notre Dame 23-13. Once a game, that game has gone to a weather delay in South Bend. Brent.
All right, Robert, so they've had problems with the weather throughout the Midwest. And I know that up in Ann Arbor, I believe that game was shortened because of weather, and they beat Western, the Wolverines did. Michael Ford checks in as a running back on this toss play, kind of hitting behind the left side, and stays on his feet with great balance. And he's down in the 30-yard line, and he was tripped up by Boyette, the fine safety.
Here's a fresh set of legs coming in with Blue, and he does a good job. So, yeah, right now, Oregon's got that play handled. But Blue doesn't give up on it. He keeps his legs moving. He bounces to the outside, gets away from the safety, Boyette, and picks up some big yards. But that's what it takes right now for LSU to be able to get some yards on the ground. It takes the back to be able to break a tackle, because there are just so many ducks up close to the line.
The youngster Beckham back on the field as a wide receiver. First and 10. And this time Lee will come up throwing. Takes a deep drop to the 20. Fires deep. Beckham can't hang on. At the 40-yard line, it'll be second and 10. And Gilden has been all over the receivers here. Now, they've got to pick on that redshirt freshman at some point.
Absolutely. And there it is on first and 10, Brent. You and I talked about, if there's a time to try it, it's on first and 10 off of play action to try to get those safeties up. This is a great call. Even though you don't hit it, you at least try to let the safeties know you have it in it. And there's the true freshman. Beckham almost comes up with it. Gilden does a good job. Gilden's made 2 good plays against Jarrett Lee.
Now, LSU has not aimed a ball down deep at Reuben Randall, number 2. He's their best veteran receiver. Remember, Russell Shepard has been suspended. So Randall, number 2, split out to the right. And Lee rolls in that direction, looking for him, tosses it out of bounds. And Randall was covered that time. As we've come to the end of the first quarter in a battle of field goals, Oregon leads LSU 6-3. This presentation of Saturday Night Football, presented by Southwest Airlines, will return after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
It's been a good year for the Chevy Silverado, and not because of the awards or the accolades. No, it was good because you told us so. The Chevy Model Year Wrap-Up. Get in on our greatest model year yet. Just announced, celebrate Labor Day with an additional $500 bonus cash. With all other offers, including the All-Star Edition discount, that's a total value of $6,500. Our greatest model year yet is wrapping up.
One consumer electronics company used to rule the living room. But then something remarkable happened. A company from right here in America rose up, promising a revolution. Now, they're the number one LCD HD TV company, with some of the industry's most awarded televisions. It's a new world. Vizio, entertainment freedom for all.
September 12th, it's back to football as Tom Brady leads the explosive Patriots against Reggie Bush and the rival Dolphins. Then the Raiders take on the Broncos. A special ESPN Monday Night Football doubleheader, September 12th.
I'm meteorologist Melissa McGee. A nice start to our Labor Day weekend. Whether you're going to be in the city, the shore, in the Poconos, we've got you covered with that AccuWeather forecast tonight on Action News after the game.
Time is running out on Toyota's nationwide clearance event. It's the perfect time to save big and get the Toyota you've been waiting for. Don't miss your last chance to take advantage of the summer's best selection and the year's biggest deals on our most popular models. Lease a fuel-efficient new 2011 RAV4 for just $219 a month, or lease a versatile new 2011 Highlander for just $269 a month. Hurry in for Labor Day weekend savings. This event ends soon.
Nissan's bottom line sales event has been extended. With better availability than Honda or Toyota, you save. Get an additional $500 holiday bonus cash on popular models like Altima, $179 plus bonus cash. Visit ChooseNissan.com. Test drive at your local Nissan dealer today. More cars, bonus cash, more savings. Hurry, and September 5th.
The Eagles kick off the 2011 season in just 8 days.
Well, Herbie, former LSU offensive coordinator Gary Croton told the Baltimore paper this week, Coach Miles, good on defense, good special teams, and tries to win the game in the fourth quarter. He's now at Maryland. He says he could be more wide open with the offense over there.
Well, let's not argue here. I mean, it's worked for LSU. That success, that plan has given him a lot of success. But I think the reason LSU fans get a little bit frustrated with Coach Miles and with LSU is because they win games, but sometimes it's excruciating to watch, and it gives you an ulcer when you're sitting at home and you're watching and they find a way to get it done. But give them credit. The formula that he has come up with defense and special teams and field position and just kind of being smart on offense, it, a lot of times they're good enough to beat most of the teams that they play. But I will say this in the second quarter, to beat Oregon tonight, and with their speed, they're going to have to do much more than just run the ball and be conservative and just try not to lose the game on offense.
Now, Barner is back deep again for the Ducks, and this is a beautiful punt. Back to the 15, running backwards, loose, free ball, touchdown, LSU. Matthew picks it up and runs in, and LSU strikes.
Cliff Harris is saying, boy, I wish I didn't make a big mistake. I wish I could be there for my teammates. But that's Les Miles football. That's part of the offense, man.
Just what we talked
it's
about.
That's on the play sheet, right? I love it. Right on cue.
Alima misses the extra.
can tell you something. When you need a play, you turn to your playmaker, Matthew. Last year, the freshman made it happen. And he gets off to a huge start here as a sophomore campaign.
A three-point lead. We'll be right back.
Southwest makes the call.
What's the call?
I've got unnecessary bag fees.
Guys, I'm just driving.
Do I penalize for each bag fee?
I would.
$120 round trip and bag fees?
Man, that's a low blow.
Guys, I gotta get going here.
Hey, you want me to throw you off the tarmac?
Bags fly free. Southwest Airlines, it's the right call.
In this changing world, it's harder than ever to find something extraordinary.
It's okay. I'm not going to hurt you.
But every once in a while, a symbol of hope breaks through.
Trying to put a tail on a fish, nobody in his right mind would even try it.
Luckily, I'm not.
Not what?
In my right mind.
And this time, her name is Winter.
I want you to custom make some parts for me.
Who's the patient?
Dolphin Tail.
Swim!
Rated PG. Starts September 23rd in 3D and 2D.
Hi.
Hi, are we still on for dinner?
Oh, I can't. You know I've got the bar exam.
Well, good luck.
Thank you. Okay, one more time. This bar means...
The Coors Light is cold.
And this bar...
The Coors Light is super cold?
Congrats, you just passed the bar exam.
Woo! Introducing new super cold activation from Coors Light. With two stages, you'll know when your beer goes from cold to super cold.
So, you're a lawyer?
Huh? No.
Frostbrewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer.
Boy, I'm glad we got Aflac, huh?
Aflac!
Oh, I've just got major medical.
Major medical.
But, helps pay the doctors.
Pays the doctors, boy!
Oh, yeah? What about your family?
We added Aflac, so we get cash. It's like our safety net. To help with the mortgage or whatever we need. So my family doesn't feel the pain, too.
Help protect your family at Aflac.com.
When everything you love has been stolen from you, someone has to pay.
ABC's Revenge premieres Wednesday, September 21st, 10, 9 central on ABC.
The LSU sideline is following that wonderful punt, Herbie.
Amazing by Brad Wing. What a job there driving back Barner.
And he's back on the field. You can see the coach encouraging him when he came off after the turnover. Here comes Barner. And he brings it out around the 25.
He's waiting right there. And even if Barner does not fumble that, the interesting thing is the way that, again, in a low-scoring game, it tilted the field. And of course, they still end up getting the break.
But another penalty against the Ducks on this kickoff return. Well, let's take a look at the Pacific Life game summary. So we've had a couple of turnovers, and both squads have struck. But LSU missed the extra point, so they lead it only 9-6 right now. Not much offense so far, only 28 yards for the Tigers. And now, Herbie, bad field position to start here for Oregon. They're back in the shadow of their own goalpost here.
This is where LSU can really come after the Oregon defense, our offense.
And they do just that, just what you said. They jam the point of attack at the 10-yard line. Anthony Johnson, remember his number, 56. He's got a great future. He's a freshman.
True freshman. They call him the freak. And how many times in the SEC have we heard a defensive lineman? That's a compliment, by the way, because of his physical ability, quickness, and power.
Tough spot here for Darren Thomas. There is the young man, Anthony Johnson. And they have put him over on that center. Grassu with his first start. Play fake. Hit on the release again. Going deep. And intercepted at the 45-yard line just across midfield. And Simon makes a fine interception on the ball.
Darren Thomas just put it up in the air and just kind of hoped that his guy would come down with it. But this is LSU. You have Mo Claiborne as a corner. You have Tyron Matthew as a corner. And the third corner is Simon. And by the way, he's 6'3", 190 pounds. Long arms And when they play nickel, they put him out there isolated one-on-one because of the confidence that they have. And that time, he goes up and over Josh Huff and makes the play. It's tough to get vertical against this LSU secondary.
Ware is on the field as the running back. Quick slant. Oh, almost. Is it picked off? He said he got it. This will go to instant replay. He's going to take it the distance. This is Boyette, who went down for the ball and took it into the end zone. But hang on here. Did he catch the football?
Brent, it's going to come down to whether or not he got his hand under the ball before the ball hit the turf. Did he get his hand under the football? Let's take a close look. It's off Peterson. A great effort by Boyette.
That ball touched
the turf.
Field was a catch.
Great effort
interception
there. By Boyette.
And then the receiver was down. The last play is under review.
Yeah, this ball is going back to LSU. At least on first look. Let me have a second look.
Ball's thrown behind Peterson.
Yeah, no question.
Again, tremendous effort, but the ball, without a doubt, hits the turf. That's a great look right there.
Yeah, a little bit of a short hop. So it's going to be LSU football. No question about that right now. Big 12 officiating crew. D. Anderson is upstairs. Jim Blackwood has run the monitor backwards and forwards. He's taking a look at the same angles that you have at home. And this one is pretty easy to determine.
Going back to the play call, first and 10, they tried to throw the ball off of play action. And I think that's going to be an important part, but I love the call there on first and 10 by Les Miles and his offensive staff.
It was ruled an interception, but no return is what they ruled. But this ball is going to be given back to LSU on an incompleted pass.
Although they must be taking plenty of looks here. I mean, you and I seem to think one look, bang, incomplete. Let's go. Second down.
I don't find this one hard.
I don't either. But they're making sure week one.
They might have been trying to figure out where the line of scrimmage was so that they can put it back is probably what they were doing at the end of it, Herbie. Not to jump on the replay official.
The football hit the ground, therefore incomplete pass. It'll be second down and 10 at the 45-yard line.
Brian brings up second and 10 after all that. And we are, what, just starting the second quarter. How many yards do we have? LSU has 28 yards, and Oregon has 60 yards of offense.
Second and 10 coming up for Jarrett Lee. There's the numbers that you referred to. From the gun, tossing to the middle, incomplete.
It's a far cry from Baylor and TCU.
Oh, what a football game that was.
Are you kidding me? Robert Griffin?
If I'm an NFL scout, I'm going into Waco this week.
Oh, without a doubt. Now, he's off this week. Stephen F. Austin and Rice get ready to crank up the Heisman machine for Robert Griffin.
He laid that ball over defenders' shoulders. Who's the last quarterback to torch a TCU defense?
He's a quarterback who happens to be athletic. He's not an athlete playing quarterback.
You would like the young man. It's basketball games. He
was on the set this morning on game day.
But that's right. He showed up with
classy
him.
Classy kid. Yeah.
Third down and 10. Firing a whoa! Lit up at the 49-yard line on third down by Michael Clay. What a future he's got as an Oregon linebacker. Hello.
And, you know, and Brent, with KC Matthews gone and Pacinger gone and Kenny Rowe gone, Michael Clay, and Nick Aliotti told us this, he's the glue this year for this defense. And that was a big-time play there. Textbook technique there on third down to give Oregon the football back.
That was Landry, who was the target, and welcome to college football. Freshman from Louisiana, part of a very, very good recruiting class. Barner is back deep, and here comes Wink. Remember that great punt? Now a fair catch by Barner up to the 20-yard line. It'll be Oregon football. They're down by 3. We'll see what Chip Kelly dials up here on offense.
Wouldn't it be cool if you took the top down on a crossover? If your car could adapt 30 times faster than you could blink? If your transmission never changed gears? Wouldn't it be cool if your car knew exactly who you were? If there were buttons for this? Wouldn't it be cool if it could handle the kids and the Nürburgring? If it had eyes down the road? If going electric could feel, well, electric? Or what if you built a car in Tennessee that could change the world? Yeah, that would be cool. Nissan. Innovation for today. Innovation for tomorrow. Innovation for all.
We have it in us to be the better men. We already are. Who's with me?
X-Men First Class.
For breakfast, try our spicy chicken biscuit.
Saturday Night Football on ABC, presented by Southwest Airlines. Find our fares online only at southwest.com. Nissan, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy. And Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's.
Now we are back in this beautiful stadium. If you ever get a chance to see the Cowboys or one of these college games, I really guarantee you'll enjoy it. Darren Thomas hands off, and Michael James looking for the all-time record. Ed's got it. I believe he's got it. He needed a couple of yards.
And he got 2.5.
2.5, he got it. Tonight, so give him the career record for the Oregon Ducks on that run. What an unbelievable career he has had so far. So your all-time leading rusher. First strike to the outside, and that's DeAnthony Thomas. Second time he's touched the ball. Boy, he shows a little dash. They better try to get the ball to him a little more often.
Well, I think Josh Huff and DeAnthony Thomas are going to have to make a difference in the pass game for Darren Thomas. His other receivers are struggling.
Quick strike out to the flanker. Gets a blocker, and that's Barner, who was out in that slot.
If you get your receivers who are really running backs, Kenyon Barner, and we talked about DeAnthony Thomas, Josh Huff, get him the ball quick in space, one-on-one, as good as LSU is, at least you have a fighting chance out there on the perimeter with the speed of those three.
Chain Gang has to keep up with this blur offense, and now Thomas looks over to the sideline, and the signal comes to see what they want to do.
Brent Matthews showed blitz. He looks like he's going to sit back now.
Michael. Tough yard.
One thing that John Chavis will ask Matthew and the rest of that secondary is when Darren Thomas gets ready to snap the ball, show him some different looks. And so when he looks over to Chip Kelly and they start to adjust to play, maybe they're thinking it's something else. So the defense can play a little bit of a cat and mouse game with Oregon as well.
Josh Huff is off to the right. Brooks backs off him. Eric Reed is the safety, motioning to Brooks that he's got help if they're coming that way. But they go back to the inside, and that's short of a first down. Paulson, the tight end, one of the tight ends in the Pac-12.
As much as we talk about all this speed for Oregon, I think the security blanket for Darren Thomas is David Paulson. Last year, he stepped in, did a good job. Dennis Dick, or you see the quarterback trusts him, and that's big.
And they pound straight ahead with Barner for the first down. They move the chains. They're into LSU territory. And again, we've got an injured player. Logan goes down. Now, the Duck fans automatically think that someone's faking an injury. Les Miles told us straight up that he's never faked an injury in his life.
Well, it's interesting that two guys go down on the same play. Brockers and Logan both down.
Both down. So we'll step away for a moment.
Ready? You can do this. Whenever you say it.
I can do this.
Go war!
I'm proud of you, Tommy.
Forgotten what I promised you.
You got him! Warrior, rated PG-13. Sneak previews tomorrow, everywhere September 9th.
As the years go by, some questions loom large. Are you prepared for your retirement years, 25 or more of them? Do you have a financial plan for your family that works, in good times and in bad times? Having the right perspective can help you answer the big questions. For more than 140 years, Pacific Life has helped find answers for those navigating the path to financial security. Ask a financial professional about Pacific Life, the power to help you succeed.
ABC's Modern Family, 1 hour season premiere, Wednesday, September 21st.
Both Logan on the left and Brockers on the right received medical attention on the sideline. Now for tonight's Aflac trivia question. Herbie, since 1936, only four schools have won the national championship after losing the first game of the season. Which is the last school to do that? And that talks about the importance of our game here tonight. The season opener between the numbers 3 and 4 teams. And now from that gun, and a handoff by the substitutes who came in for Logan and Brockers, and there was absolutely nothing doing it there.
One quick question. Is it in the BCS era?
No, it is not. It's not in the BCS era. Second and long. Thomas got to go deep, and his receiver slipped. So it'll be third down and long as a result of that play.
He wanted Barner on the wheel route, and Barner goes out man-to-man. He's going up against a really good guy. Not only did he slip, it's just a little bit of confusion there between Darren Thomas and Barner, who looked like he wanted to stop and break his route off against Matthew.
Third and 11. Fires for the first down at the 35-yard line. He puts it in Huff's hands for the first down. What a big strike that is.
And that's a big-time play by Josh Huff. He's a high school running back, also from the state of Texas in Houston. And did you see how Darren Thomas put the ball back where there was space in the zone? He threw it back, and really a nice job by Josh Huff using his hands that time to secure the football.
14 yards on that third and 11. Firing again on first down, and a diving reception at the 31. So they pick up a handful of yards, and that's Thomas's third catch of the night, the freshman from Crenshaw High School.
It's interesting, Brent, the big adjustment that they have made here in the second corner. DeAnthony Thomas is a running back, and he's lined up in a slot to the left. Kenyon Barner's a running back. He's a slot to the right.
Trying to use both of them. Good protection. Another first down to the 22, and that's that freshman. Folks, remember number 6. He was great in scrimmages this fall. The coaching staff knew what they had.
And that's a great in-game adjustment by Chip Kelly in this offense. The 2A and the rest of the receivers are not matching up to the athletic ability of LSU. Put Barner and Thomas out there and try to get the passing game going. The reason that's important, Brent, is then you can get back to your bread and butter of Darren Thomas and LaMichael James running the football.
And Grassu is holding up in his first start as a center. He identifies the Mike linebacker. Quick strike to the outside. 2A across the 20 and still going. And he is at the 15-yard line. That's a huge first down play.
And again, getting the ball out. This time it's 2A. Hoffman does a good job of picking up a block, sustaining his block. And what about the effort for the long, lanky 2A? LSU defenders all over the place, and he's able to hold on to the football.
Up tempo when they get down into that red zone. Throwing. 2A short of the end zone. There is a penalty flag. There is a penalty flag on this throw. 2A down in a heap at about the 4-yard line.
Personal foul. Leg whip on the offense, number 70. 15-yard penalty. Second down.
Another LSU defender going down.
That personal fouls on Gopassion right there. Is this a leg whip here, Herbie? Is that what he described down there? As we have Edwards down and still another LSU player down.
Looks like LeVar Edwards, who is down for LSU. Incidentally, Brockers, who was down earlier, is back in the game for LSU. Now the defensive end Edwards is down. But it's really fun to watch John Chavis, LSU's defensive mind, and Chip Kelly going back and forth, the adjustments that are being made. And right now Chip Kelly seems to have the upper hand.
One of the things we want to point out here is that the distraction that beset LSU, when I see players dropping a little bit, you wonder about the conditioning. You wonder how much they were distracted by these things that went on in Baton Rouge. That unspecified number of players involved in that fight outside the bar. The police then interviewed four players, including their starting quarterback. Wide receiver Russell Shepard was suspended, but that did not involve the brawl outside the bar. And then Jordan Jefferson and backup linebacker Josh Johns were arrested and suspended. I'm always suspicious of what happens with a coaching staff and a group of players when things like this happen. How much they're able to work, how much they're able to concentrate at the very least. Jordan Jefferson, of course, suspended indefinitely. That's why we have Jared Lee. And here we have another player down.
Looks like Edwards will get up. And, you know, with Oregon, Brent, trying to take advantage of this drive and the momentum that's been created, another self-inflicted wound with that leg whip, and it puts them way back to the 30-yard line. I mean, they were trying to get the ball inside the five on that play, and now they're back to a second down and long at the 30-yard line.
Herbie, that's 56 yards of penalties against Oregon.
Yeah, absolutely. And big ones. Crucial moments in the game.
So they're back to their 13th play, and suddenly, just as you pointed out, they got second and 17.
Yeah, they don't have an offensive play longer than 14 yards tonight. So see if they can make the adjustment here on second long.
Thomas with the play call. Plenty of time. The play clock. Gonna run the draw play. And this is LaMichael James. And he crosses the 20, and now it becomes manageable on third down. What a beautiful run on second down.
See, Brent, all those quick throws to the outside, it's catching the attention of the outside linebackers in the secondary. And that's when you can get back to getting the ball run vertically by LaMichael James. It's a delicate balance between on the perimeter quickly and then upfield also quickly with LaMichael James.
Let's see who Thomas looks for here. Under fire. Anthony Thomas, the red-hot freshman.
This kid has five catches, known as a running back, but they moved him out the receiver tonight along with Barner. And right now he is winning the one-on-one matchups and getting separation to give Darren Thomas a chance to make throws.
So they pick it up, but it was that second down that gave him a chance.
Look at LSU's defense. Some fatigue, hands on hips. That's what Oregon wants. They want to wear them down. See, Baker.
Comes a blitz. Matthew was trying to come, and he says an offensive lineman moved.
False start. It's the little things with Tyrann Matthew that makes him who he is. I mean, that will never show up in the stats. It's never going to show up. But just by him starting to accelerate and attack the line of scrimmage, the linemen, they flinch. They move because they're trying to time up the potential blitz. But that's Matthew. That sums him up. This guy makes so many plays for this LSU football team.
And their other freshman, that right guard, Gopassion, has picked up a couple of costly penalties here on this drive. And it makes it first and 15. Darren Thomas on the move to the left. It's complete to the 15-yard line. So that doesn't gain too much for him. 2-and-A, the receiver. Now here's your offensive line, and you can see those two first starts there. Now Grasso, he's held up so far very well.
But
Gopassion in this drive's had a couple of costly penalties.
This is 16th play of this drive for Oregon.
Second down, end zone too high, incomplete. Double coverage down there in that corner of the end zone. You can see the two defenders there with DeAnthony Thomas. They were looking for the freshman this time.
Well, he's got some energy. I love watching DeAnthony Thomas, true freshman, living out a dream, finally getting a chance to play college football, and look who he's going up against in his first game, LSU, and he's not stepping back one iota. He's ready to play ball tonight.
Third down and 12. Got to get to the 3-yard line if you want to get a first set of downs. Field goal would tie the score. Timeout. Timeout is called. The time running down on this third down play. Well, we talked about Aflac, Herbie, and it is before the BCS era. Can you recall?
How about Notre Dame?
No, it's just a guess, okay? Four schools have won the national championship after losing the first game. The last school to do it back in 1983, a dramatic bowl game. It was Miami. Do you remember Tom Osborne that night in Nebraska coming back down? Let's flash back. Some of you folks remember this.
Gosh.
Courageous Tom Osborne. A tie would have probably given him the national championship. But he went for the two in the win.
Jeff
not
Smith?
To get it.
Yeah, Jeff Smith, I think it was. Drop set.
And as a result, Miami wins the national championship. I believe they lost to Florida, as I recall.
That was
their first game. And Schnellenberger won his national championship with the Hurricanes that night. All right, here we are. Third down and 12 for the Ducks. They're down by three. There's movement in that line again.
You know, on those third downs, in this environment where the crowd becomes a factor with communication up front, you're almost better off going with a quicker snap because those offensive linemen start to sit there and they get anxious. I mean, they're looking across the line of scrimmage at this LSU defensive line. They're trying to figure out who's coming, who's dropping, and they start to get anxious on that snap count waiting that long.
It would now be about a 37-yard field goal if they don't gain anything here for Beard for the tie. Third and long. Thomas fires middle, and it is penalty flag. There's a penalty flag thrown, and if that's a penalty, that's going to be a first down.
Brent, I think he led with his crown of his helmet. The safety, Craig Austin, looked like he'd led with the crown of his helmet to try to disengage the receiver.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness.
That's a first down. They did not have the first down.
Distance to the ball. Automatic. First down.
Oh, that's a huge personal foul.
Watch him lower his helmet. This is something you just cannot do. You see it in the NFL and in college football. When you lower your headgear to lower the boom, they're going to call it every time.
So now, after the reception, keep that in mind, then it's penalized across the 5-yard line. Tuane made a great grab.
Absolutely.
Under enormous pressure. And here we go for the Ducks trying to grab the lead. First and goal from the 4-yard line. LaMichael James is next to Thomas.
Remember, Thomas likes to run the football here himself as well.
LaMichael James picks his way, but not much doing against it. Downs, Brockers. Brockers back on the field. Downs next to him, and now it'll be second down and goal. Tough going.
Tough sledding in there, boys.
Hello.
But I talked about Thomas, when he can run the football, a lot of times he has most of his touchdowns. They get inside the 5-yard line. They pay so much attention to the backfield and LaMichael James. Sometimes it can open up seams.
LaMichael, touchdown, Oregon leads. When you talk about Heisman Trophy candidates, folks, do not forget LaMichael James.
The check to the left. They've got a bubble off to the left, and a good job that time by the line picking up the stunt. And there's a nice big void on that left side where they were able to make the check. York came around and made a good block.
And LaMichael James basically just walks into the end zone.
So here is Rob Beard on for the extra point. Jackson Rice is the holder. And he adds it. So this is a drive, folks, that consumed 19 plays, went 79 yards, 7 minutes and 41 seconds, and LaMichael James takes it in for 6.
Running backs don't stand in line. We run through them, especially with Nike Pro Comeback Hyper Strong. Nike Pro Combat.
I forgot my wallet, Steven Jackson.
Take every advantage. Nike Pro Combat Hyper Strong at Dick's Sporting Goods. Better athlete, better team.
Look at all this stuff for coffee.
Oh, there's tons. French presses, espresso tampers, filters. It can get really complicated. Not nearly as complicated as shipping it, though. I mean, shipping is a hassle.
Not with Priority Mail flat rate boxes from the Postal Service. If it fits, it ships anywhere in the country for a low flat rate.
That is easy. Best news I've heard all day. I'm so amped! I mean, not amped, excited. I mean, that is sort of amped. Really kind of in between.
Have you ever thought about decaf?
You think that'll help?
Yeah.
Priority Mail flat rate shipping starts at just $4.95, only from the Postal Service. A simpler way to ship.
Good news, men use soap. Bad news, men use soap that can really dry their skin. Fear not, Dove Men Plus Care is here. It's the bar with 1/4 moisturizing cream, so it cleans and leaves skin feeling moisturized. Dove Men Plus Care.
People, it's time for a better tablet. It's time to tab. Time for better graphics and faster gaming performance. A better HD screen and faster downloads. Better creating, multitasking, and better, faster uploads with 4G LTE. The thinner, lighter, faster Samsung Galaxy Tab. That's the wonder of Samsung.
Introducing the 60 Seconds of Mayhem Sweepstakes. You could win a new car and kick a field goal at the Allstate BCS National Championship for a boat, motorcycle, RV, and a home makeover. January 9th is gonna be mayhem. Will you be there? Enter at allstatecfb.com.
Aerial coverage provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned making tires for superior performance inspires what they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven. Right now, Oregon is coming off its best drive of the night. James with his 36th rushing touchdown in 26 career games. Now, LSU's turn. See what they can do. Claiborne and Brooks back deep. This is Claiborne in the end zone. He's going to bring this one out. 15, 20. The gamble paid off. And let us go down below to Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brent, when LSU's defense returned to the bench, D-line coach Rick Haley gave him a piece of their mind, telling them that was a cheap play right there. That was a cheap score by LaMichael James. That's what happens when you play undisciplined. Brent, he unloaded on this D-line, and I have to tell you, he looks as exhausted as these defenders right here.
I think after that 19-play drive, that entire defense was not only physically fatigued, but also mentally fatigued.
Spencer Ware back in as the running back. Battles for a couple of tough yards here on first down. But the Tigers are going to have to get to an early passing situation.
They have 11 yards rushing. Oregon with his new defensive front and a lot of new linebackers, 11 yards rushing.
Pounding the run, and that time they break it for a first down. That's the best run of the night.
Sure is.
Out to the 45-yard line, and it picks up a first down with Spencer Ware.
Spencer Ware follows the big fullback that time, James Stampley, and offensive line gets a push.
Now it's LSU trying to pick the tempo up offensively. Close to midfield on that first down, and they're working behind the middle. That Lonergan, T. Bob Hebert, and Will Blackwell in the middle of that offensive line. T. Bob Hebert, and of course, that's the son of Bobby Hebert. Many of you remember, a longtime quarterback in the National Football League. Randall has not been a target tonight. He's down to the near side. Michael Ford is the running back. He's going to stick right on the ground. Now, why not? Busting across the 40-yard line, and now that offensive line is starting to exert itself here, Herbie.
And they do a good job. Tight end that time picks up a block. Outstanding vision by Michael Ford. Finds that cutback. Is able to get up inside that crease very quickly.
They're on first down. They throw the lob to the running back. And one of the receivers, let me check myself on that. That was Michael Ford as he had slipped out.
Ford trying to give Spencer Ware a little bit of a break here because of his speed. He has probably the most acceleration in that LSU backfield.
Lee steps away from trouble. Going to be sacked. Back at the 44-yard line, Jared Lee is taken down by Kadu, Josh Kadu.
And that's where the lack of experience comes in to really hurt Jared Lee. See, he's got to be able to just throw that football away and avoid the loss, avoid taking the big sack and killing the momentum of this drive. And once again, it puts this LSU offense into a third and long situation. It allows Nick Aliotti either to get creative and bring pressure or rush three and drop eight. They're one of six tonight on third down.
Down to 3 seconds. Got it off, fires middle, and grabbed at the 22-yard line. Fine catch by D'Angelo Peterson, his first of the night, and what a grab.
And he finds a one-on-one matchup that he can win, and he gave Peterson just enough time. Peterson does a good job of securing the football. You know, he's 6'4", about 235 pounds as a tight end, former wide receiver, and he's one-on-one against Eddie Pleasant at about 5'11", and that time Lee has enough time to find the matchup that he wanted to exploit.
18 yards on that passing play. Ware is back. Goes for the edge on the left side. That's a good gain on first down into the red zone.
Now they're outflanking the Oregon defensive edge. There's a defensive end and Deion Jordan, or sometimes an outside linebacker like Michael Clay or Josh Kadu. They are motioning a tight end to try to get to the outside. And by doing that, it's allowing the back to make a decision to either bounce it to the outside or cut it back underneath on the zone play.
Toss play to Ford, and he is eaten up. So here comes a huge third down with a minute and a half to go. LSU has all three of its timeouts. Now let's check in quickly with Robert Flores.
All right, Brent. Boise State and Georgia from the Georgia Dome, and the Broncos go on top. Kellen Moore to Kyle Efoy, who uses the truck stick to get into the end zone. Georgia led 7-0, but now they trail late in the second quarter. Meantime, South Carolina spotted East Carolina's 17-0 lead, but Steven Garcia has led the Gamecocks back. They're up 4 in the third quarter. Brent.
Garcia did not start. Is that what I remember on the game day hearing?
Interesting. He has two rushing touchdowns. If there are a couple quarterback sneaks, but South Carolina on the ropes here on week one. We got a big game next week with Georgia. Both those teams next week.
All right, minute 34 to go. LSU coming up with that big third and 7 down right here. Dave Aliotti, time to get the defense ready. Is there a penalty? Yes, there is.
Oh, yeah.
And that's an automatic first down.
First time he's looked up Reuben Randall, and Eddie Pleasant was all over him. Eddie Pleasant gave up that first down, the previous third down to Peterson, and that time he said, I'm not going to let anybody catch the ball.
And 11.
Got in there way too early.
Spot of the foul. First down.
That spot of the foul was right about the 14-yard line.
Jarrett Lee feeling that pressure, but sat in there, showed some toughness, and delivered the football. But
Kadu getting some medical attention, taping up that ankle. Meanwhile, LSU with a golden opportunity here. Only a minute and a half left in the first half. Ware to the 10 and across. And it will be second down. Les wants to keep the clock moving.
Time obviously not really a big factor here yet with the three timeouts, even though we're closing in on a minute.
LSU's got three timeouts, so there's no need taking them on into the to the locker room. Fumble. Battle for the loose ball. That was an exchange problem, I believe, as Jarrett was pulling away from Lonergan. Did it hit him?
I think hit one of his linemen who were trying to pull around. I think maybe Abear bumped the football as he was coming around to be able to help out with a block off to the right. That ball seemed to sit there forever until Ware finally jumped on it.
Well, coming up on the Northwestern Mutual Halftime Report, John and Jesse will have all the day's big highlights. So that's coming your way at halftime as college football is off and rolling. And Herbie, Lonergan appeared to be in some pain down there. And I don't know if they'll switch T-Bob Hebert over to center. He has played some if they have to take Lonergan out here.
Well, they've already lost Josh Dorosik, who's really the leader of this defense. He's out with a knee. And Lonergan is kind of taking that role of being the guy up front. He is clearly in a lot of pain. But I don't think he wants to come out right now. He wants to finish his drive off, and they can check him out at halftime.
Coming back on the field for this third and six.
See if the Ducks try to dial up some pressure here. They've gotten close to Lee on the last two third downs.
Ware looks like he wants to jitterbug off to the left and see if he can get something on an edge. Let's see what they do here from the gun. Gonna throw for it. Got one on one. Touchdown, Randall. First catch of the night. And it's for the go-ahead touchdown. They finally found the redshirt freshman corner.
Yes, they did. And we just said, are they going to dial up some pressure? And they did. And when you do, you're one-on-one. LSU thought when they got into the red zone that Randall, with his size at 6'4", could go after Mitchell at about 5'11". They hit the tight end earlier, Peterson, on this drive. And this time for the touchdown, they find Reuben Randall, the junior.
Remember, they did not convert their last extra point. The Alamans could on this one. So LSU takes a three-point lead, 16-13, with 44 seconds to go. And Herbie, we've been saying it throughout much of the evening that LSU had to dial up a forward pass. In fact, you said they're not going to win this game unless they complete some passes. And here they go ahead on a touchdown pass.
Yeah, but I also want to give credit to LSU and their coaching staff and the patience that they've shown, because really that entire drive was set up by them finally taking control of the line of scrimmage. And I just said before this drive started, what was it, 11 yards that they had rushing coming into this drive? But they didn't get away from their game plan. They continued to say, hey, we know we eventually can take control of things. And that particular drive, they were able to do it. And also Jarrett Lee. But he talked about how is he going to perform in this game. Converts a big third down, picks up the pass interference, and then, of course, throws the touchdown on the fade to Reuben Randall. So an outstanding drive in kind of the typical LSU fashion.
And we have gone back and forth here in the first half. A very entertaining college football showdown because the teams are ranked number 3 and number 4. We showed you in the Aflac trivia. You know, it used to be a bit of a cliche that you can lose early and still get back to the championship. Don't lose late. That has not been the case in the BCS era and hasn't been the case since the early 80s. You do not want to lose your opener. High kickoff going to be fielded short at the 15-yard line by Barner. 40 seconds remaining here, and of course, only two races left until the chase. Tony Stewart and Dale Earnhardt Jr. got to pick it up a little bit. NASCAR Sprint Cup Series Atlanta presented by Pennzoil. Coverage begins on ESPN Sunday, 6:30 Eastern. Atlanta is always a great stop. We were down there the last couple of years for a football game and had a chance to go out to the track, and we're coming right down to crunch time. with the NASCAR fellas. First down and 10. Final 40 seconds. And Chip Kelly not going to get crazy here.
Real quick, let's just show Kiki Mingo. How many defensive ends do you know in college football that run a 4-5? A 4-5. Brent says they were talking to us yesterday at the walkthrough. Kiki Mingo could play safety for LSU. They got him lined up at defensive end.
Isn't that something?
he just walked LaMichael James down for a short loss. I just want to see him run. Can we see him run again on that last play, just showing him in full speed? That was beautiful. My gosh. Watch him coming from the backside. Watch him. He gets into full stride. That's LaMichael James he's chasing down. They got some guys up front that can go. He is 6'5", about 240 pounds. And John Chavis really told us that last year was the first year that he felt as a coordinator in Baton Rouge, he finally had some defensive ends, SEC defensive ends, and he's got them back this year.
LaMichael picks his way. Let me check that. That was Barner who had replaced LaMichael after that run. So Kenyon Barner, the ball carrier that time. And the final seconds ticking away here. A lot of LSU fans here tonight, and they are on their feet. As now it is James receiving some attention on the sideline. Darren Thomas bringing the troops off the field, and let's go down below to Aaron Andrews.
We'll start with that 19-play scoring drive. What finally went right?
And we stopped shooting ourselves in the foot. You know, we've got penalties on our side of the ball and turned the ball over a couple of times, and we got too many drops. But, you know, we're starting to get into a rhythm, so we'll see.
What's the biggest thing you stress here with the Tigers up by 3?
It's a great game, and it's only a 3-point game, so we got to come out and we just got to try to stop shooting ourselves in the foot. Got to stay away from the penalties, got to stay away from the drops, got to stay away from that turnovers.
Thanks for your time.
Okay.
All right, Brian.
It is indeed a good game. So let's send it to the studio. Big John Saunders and Smooth Jesse Pomper.
Brent, you never fail to disappoint. Northwestern Mutual halftime report, and as advertised, a great one to start the season. Now, LSU has the lead, but you're a little bit surprised they're not getting their passing game going as well as you expected.
LSU wants to line up in an I formation, and they want to run the ISO play, the lead play, and the power play. But when Oregon puts 8 players close to the line of scrimmage, LSU has to be able to take advantage of matchups on the perimeter of the field and hurt Oregon throwing the football deep down. Down the sidelines or down the middle of the field right here. There were some good throws from Jarrett Lee. There's a drop here by the tight end earlier in the game. Later, you see again, 8 players close to the line of scrimmage. Jarrett Lee takes a chance down the left sideline. It's another very, very catchable throw, and the opportunity is lost. Wide receivers Reuben Randall or freshman Odell Beckham have to step up. They have to make plays out on the perimeter of the field. LSU has to force Oregon to put 2 safeties back in center field, so there's less bodies close to the line of scrimmage. LSU can get back to running the football with those power formations that they want to.
If recent history tells us anything, it's that the SEC is going to find their way to the BCS championship game, and in the last 5 years win the BCS championship game. So, South Carolina, a lot of people think that they're going to come out of the East, but taking on East Carolina in Charlotte today. Stephen Garcia did not get the start, but when he got in the game, he finds Ace Sanders.
He's already accounted for 2 rushing touchdowns plus that passing touchdown to Sanders.
Dominic Davis doesn't get the ball from Doug Polichak. Reginald Bowens recovers. South Carolina gets the ball. And then Stephen Garcia keeps it himself.
South Carolina fumbled the football 4 times in the first half. It led to 17 East Carolina points. The South Carolina defense has now forced 3 turnovers in the second half, and now all of a sudden they're back on top.
Battle of Powers, Boise State against Georgia. Mark Richt has been a tremendous coach at Georgia, underappreciated. Brandon Boykin takes the handoff and goes 80 yards.
Brandon Boykin's the starting quarterback for Georgia, and he tweeted this week and dared Boise State head coach Chris Peterson to kick the football off to him. It hasn't happened yet, but he makes his presence felt here on offense.
Tweeting. We're going to get you tweeting in a moment. Kellen Moore, though, He's back for another tour. Finds Matt Miller 17 yards.
Two touchdown passes on the night so far. He's winning the quarterback duel between him and Aaron Murray from Georgia.
Last year's national champions, Gene Chizik, ranked 23rd, coming in against Utah State. They struggled. Robert Turbin barrels into the end zone for a touchdown. 38-28 lead. Now Cam Newton is gone. He's in Carolina. Bear Trotter's his replacement. Philip Lutzenkirchen, 15-yard touchdown. Auburn within three. And then, Jess, the onside kick. Emory Blake recovers it.
Emory Blake, the former quarterback, had a big touchdown reception earlier in the game. None bigger than this, though. The reception on the onside kick to keep possession.
Yeah, they take it back to the 44, but Auburn still marches it down, and Michael Dyer scores 42-38. Utah State hangs its head as they let one get away from them. Alabama, many people think they may go to the national championship game this year, facing Kent State. Nick Saban against his alma mater. Trent Richardson just as good as ever.
Three touchdowns on the ground for Trent Richardson, but those young Alabama quarterbacks combined for four interceptions. They got a big matchup next week at Penn State.
Andrew Luck was in action. Oklahoma, the number one team as well.
Kickoff week.
Presented by Southwest Airlines as part of Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week. Well, we take a look at tonight's Southwest Airlines playbook. The lead changed hands four times in this game, and we had three touchdowns overall, Kirk.
It's been interesting to watch this game unfold, and LSU with the crowd and the momentum early in this game took advantage of some mistakes by Oregon. We saw Tyrann Mathieu make a play, and all of a sudden Oregon came back, and it looked like they were able to settle in offensively after making some adjustments. LaMichael James did what he had to do, but right before the half, Reuben Randall, his first catch of the night, goes up and over the redshirt freshman Terrence Mitchell. And LSU has that three-point lead. But it's a great second half about to start.
Exactly. And Oregon, of course, has to control the mistakes, the penalties, drop passes, missed blocks, false starts, things like that. They've got to pick that up against this team.
And remember last year, we caught a bunch of Oregon games. They were stronger always in the second half because of their in-game adjustments by Chip Kelly on really both sides of the ball. And they have not had a play over 14 yards. And this is an offense known for big playability, but LSU has been able to contain them. And the other thing is, LSU's last drive, about 75 yards, eight running plays. They found something that they liked. I want to see if they're able to go back to that and have some success, because they haven't been able to run the ball outside of that drive.
And that redshirt freshman for Oregon in that secondary, replacing Cliff Harris, he better get ready.
He better get ready. They found him last drive, the touchdown by Randall. Also, we noticed that Michael James kind of limping off. We're going to take a close look at that to see. I think Mingo, when he chased him down in the second to last play in the first half, may have dinged LaMichael James. We'll see how much he's going to be able to be involved for the Ducks in the second half.
So LSU will handle the ball. Remember, they won the coin flip, and they deferred, and they will have a first down around the 20-yard line with Claiborne on the return as we check in with Aaron Andrews.
Guys, just to update you on LaMichael James, he actually didn't run out with the team out of the tunnel coming out from halftime. And I asked the Oregon athletic training staff what was going on with that leg. They say it's just cramps. He's been stretching out over here on the sidelines. You see him with the big smile on his face. They actually said a couple of these guys are cramping up. So drinking up the Gatorade down here, we'll see how they hold up in the second half.
So here we are. Jarrett Lee, the senior quarterback from Brenham, Texas, a couple hundred miles from Arlington, set to take the first snap. Play fake, throw. There's the first down pass for another first down.
Great call.
Out to the 32-yard line. They open up, and there's Peterson's second grab of the game.
Great call on first and 10. You're, of course, after the last drive, expecting, oh, they're going to run the football. They've been running all night. Little hot pass there, and they catch the linebackers out of position coming in to stop Ware. And Peterson showing some athletic ability there with a nice grab.
Now Lee moves up under center, and they come back with Ware, the running back. See if they can wear down this front seven of the Ducks. Turner making the stop for Oregon, but it's a good gain on first down. A very manageable second down.
For LSU, they're going hurry up, but a pop pass, a little throw on first and 10 does wonders to get back to running the football.
They'll come right back with a running play. As we take a look at the Pacific Life game summary, and we compare Jared Lee here of LSU with Darren Thomas of Oregon, and you can see that Thomas is thrown for 121 yards, but he has the lone interception.
It stands out to me, 28 pass attempts, and a lot of that has to do with the respect that Oregon has for LSU and the way they're able to negate the running game. So they've had to make the adjustment, of course, and throw the football to try to get back to being able to eventually run the ball with James.
Ford is on the field for this third and short. Gets the carry, and it's a first down as he powers across. This was set up by a strong first down. Even though they didn't get anything on second, you can come back and you can manage a third and two.
Great to see Lonergan out there for LSU. Remember on that drive, that scoring drive, he had some injuries. It looks like some kind of injury he was trying to deal with. He kind of fought through that, and that time he picked up the key block there. And you saw the cut by Ford right behind the block by Lonergan to spring loose Ford for that first down.
Randall is off to Lee's left. Press coverage by the Ducks on that side. Lee looks at it. Going to go deep now. Got one-on-one, and it is incomplete. He overthrew Randall.
Love the call. Both first and tens that they've had to start this second half. Big adjustment that LSU must be thinking about. Coach Studd, the offensive coordinator, is even if we're not going to hit them, let's throw the ball a little bit on first and 10. Let those linebackers and let those safeties know that we're not afraid to take some chances with Jarrett Lee and these receivers. Even if you miss it, it makes them freeze and hesitate just for a second. And then, of course, they can still run the football.
That's the hand of Ware, Spencer Ware, number 11, receiving a little attention. He's off the field right now on the second down and 10. You want to set a screen. Sort of a naked play. They let everybody come in and tried to throw it to Ford out here on the flat, and now it is suddenly third and 10.
That's the risk that you take, of course, when you take the chance on first and 10. If you miss it, they're trying to set up that screen, but the penetration just too quick by the Oregon defense. Cannot say enough about the Oregon front. They're breaking in three new starters. They're breaking in two new linebackers. They have held up so far. They're down 16-13. They're playing one of the most powerful teams in the SEC, and they're holding up very, very well.
Trips to the right. He rolls the pocket in that direction, comes in underneath again to Peterson. But that is well short of the first down.
Good speed that time. LSU trying to move that launch point in case Oregon brought pressure. They rolled Lee away from the pressure. But when you roll out, you have half the field to work with, and the Ducks do a good job of keeping the play in front of them and being able to make that tackle to force this punt here on fourth down.
So Brad Wing in to punt again. Young man from Melbourne, Australia. They say he can punt with either his right or his left. We have seen nothing but the right foot tonight. Barner turned it over on one of his great punts. He's back deep. There's the left. Runs up, got it on the 15-yard line, and out of bounds, but he did get across the 20-yard line. So when we come back, it'll be the Ducks' first possession here of the second half.
Southwest makes the call.
Please swipe credit card.
What? You gotta be kidding me. I am absolutely not paying this fee.
Hey, let's keep it above the wallet.
Unbelievable.
I've got Ruffin, the passenger's wallet.
You okay, son?
Yeah, thanks, Ruff.
Looks like they hit you with the feet pretty hard.
Sure did. Good call,
Ruff. Please swipe credit card.
Look, see?
That's it. You're gone.
Bags fly free. Southwest Airlines. It's the right call.
Want to check out the best place to be this summer? You better hurry. There's still time to get into the best-selling brand in America. And when you're cruising around town in a Ford Fusion, you're cruising in style. And on the highway, you're getting 33 miles per gallon. Plus, Ford Fusion was ranked the most dependable among midsize cars by J.D. Power and Associates. So when's the best time to get a great deal? That's still right now. Hurry into the final days of the Ford Best Place to Be sales event and get a Fusion with 0% financing for 60 months.
The Ford Best Place to Be sales event. It's still the best place to be.
Sprint introduces America's first 3D phone.
Now anyone can watch and shoot video in 3D.
Cut, guys, we're not making effective use of the 3D technology. I think I can help. You stand over there and film Daddy. Volley for serve.
Oh, what was that?
That was 3D gold. That's what that was.
Let's make homemade 3D the next big thing. The new HTC Evo 3D, no glasses required, only from Sprint.
One Coors Light coming up. Here you go.
Thanks. Bob, sweet setup.
Yeah, ever since I got this Coors Light home draft, it's like having a bar at home. Thanks.
What's your girlfriend gonna say? I got that covered.
You're not on the list.
Bob has a list?
And you're not on it.
The Coors Light Home Draft. CO2 pressurized for up to 30 days of fresh frost-brewed draft beer right from your fridge.
Big Daryl, give it up.
How you doing, Sarah? Good to see you.
Come on, really?
Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer.
Clipper 22, rolling up.
Better than sex, right?
It's just so good.
Not this one. Consider her restricted airspace.
ABC's Pan Am takes off Sunday, September 25th on ABC.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
LaMichael James will open up the second half. Remember, he was a little bit shaken up at the end of the first half. He's in there. There's the mesh point. He's got the first carry. And Logan is back on the field, helps stuff that play down there. And Brockers, his buddy, slowed it down. Now we will see if Oregon can get to the up-tempo, but now LaMichael's limping back off, so he apparently is injured here.
Yeah, whether it's cramps or an injury, it happened late in the first half. Now you have an offensive lineman, Darian Weems, down as well. It's a young offensive line, and one of their more experienced guys, Weems, at least had some experience. Now he goes out.
And Clanton will replace him, so three very green offensive linemen. Barner will be the running back, and this is going to be third and long coming up in that front with Montgomery jumping all over them. Clanton had his hands full with Montgomery.
Yeah, Clanton, welcome in. Welcome in at left tackle. This game's moving fast. The play is developing too slow. This is the end of the first half. They might be talking about a cramp, but Mingo, when he chased him from behind, looked like he might have stepped on the back of the leg of LaMichael James.
Danger here. LSU will try to team up. He gets it off incomplete. It is three and out. And that defensive front of LSU dominated that series of downs.
Boy, and Hoffman that time just could not get away from press coverage. Darren Thomas is sitting there. He's got enough time. He's waiting and waiting. And the receiver, Justin Hoffman, look at him. Look at him. You got to get off of him to give Thomas a chance to be able to execute the passing game.
Claiborne will be back deep, and LSU could wind up. Let me check that. I think that's Matthew back deep. It is Matthew. He'll field this punt at the 36 and down on the 34. Fearless. Didn't go for the fair catch in that situation. Want to see what he can do, and we'll come back to Cowboys Stadium in a moment.
Want to check out the best place to be this summer? You better hurry. There's still time to get into the best-selling brand in America. And when you're cruising around town in a Ford Fusion, you're cruising in style. And on the highway, you're getting 33 miles per gallon. Plus, Ford Fusion was ranked the most dependable among midsize cars by J.D. Power and Associates. So when's the best time to get a great deal? That's still right now.
Hurry into the final days of the Ford Best Place to Be sales event and get a Fusion with 0% financing for 60 months.
The Ford Best Place to Be sales event. It's still the best place to be.
It has an HD webcam, killer audio, and lids that switch to start every semester fresh. But mostly, it helps me try new moves on and off the court. Powered by the second-gen Intel Core processor family. Not just smart, visibly smart. Get an Inspiron 15R with 6GB memory and 640GB hard drive for $599.99 at Dell.com.
Walls can talk. But it's our job to make them say something interesting. So how about this weekend we learn some new tricks of the trade? Then break out our doing clothes and get rolling. Let's use some paint that helps us get the job done in record time and makes a statement when we're finished. Let's find ourselves a new favorite color. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Get $5 off gallon cans of our top paint brands now through September 7th only.
Emily, check this out. Oh my gosh.
Register for a free breakfast entree, redeemable September 6th through 10th. Visit ChickfilAforBreakfast.com.
Saturday Night Football on ABC, presented by Southwest Airlines. Find our fares online, only at southwest.com. Ford, Drive One, and Pacific Life. For insurance, annuities, and investments, choose Pacific Life, the power to help you succeed.
A three-point game, and Barner down there being worked on.
Barner and LaMichael James also getting worked on. Even though we're indoors and they've got the roof closed, cramps are an issue.
A short handoff to Hilliard, who lined up the freshman as the fullback, and Oregon jumped that play. They were ready for that. Didn't fool anybody, so it'll be second down. Turner read it perfectly, made the stop for Alioti. Low-scoring opener between the teams ranked number 3, Oregon, and number 4, LSU. 16-13, the lead has changed hands 4 times here in the first half. And now Jarrett Lee, the senior quarterback, will see what he can do with the Tigers of the SEC. On the toss play to Ware, and he is eaten up. Puts him in third and long, and Gildon, who's played very well as a defensive back here tonight. And
Brent, this is a check with me at the line of scrimmage, and Jarrett Lee's got to see this. Eddie Pleasant walks up. That's a safety. You've got 8 men up in the line of scrimmage. He actually checks to this play, and then you got a corner coming down as well. You're dealing with 9-10 men at the line of scrimmage. He's got to see that and check out of that and get to a quick game or something to throw the ball to the outside.
Beckham, the freshman, is split out to the left-hand side in this obvious passing situation for LSU. Lee is only 9 of 19 for 69 yards. 20th pass of the game, incomplete. Dropped as he came across midfield that time. Patterson was there on coverage for the Ducks.
Really good effort that time. Avery Patterson was trailing Boone. Ball underthrown just a bit. He needed to put a little bit more loft on that ball to try to get it into Boone. But good coverage that time by Avery Patterson and LSU. We talked about maybe they found something at the end of the first half, but these first two drives, they're out of there, and Oregon gets the football back.
So now, runner back deep. Kenyatta awaits the punt. Beautiful punt. Wow, sends it back inside the 10. Shakes a tackle at the 5, but he's down as the second man gets to him. They have found a weapon with this punter. Played Australian rules football out of Melbourne, and he buries the Ducks.
As the years go by, some questions loom large. Are you prepared for your retirement years, 25 or more of them? Do you have a financial plan for your family that works in good times and in bad times? Having the right perspective can help you answer the big questions. For more than 140 years, Pacific Life has helped find answers for those navigating the path to financial security. Ask a financial professional about Pacific Life, the power to help you succeed.
Look at that guy. He's your own flesh and blood. Right now, your hatred for him is biblical. He's been tearing apart your secondary for years, and now he says he's figured out why your passing game's so weak. It's because you have small hands, and you wet the bed. But he's getting sloppy and blitzing on every down. So suddenly, you're just a few quick slant passes away from finally kicking his
ass. Matt, NFL 12. This year, take your rivalry to 12. Rated E for everyone. EA Sports. It's in the game.
Want to check out the best place to be this summer? You better hurry.
There's still time to get into the best-selling brand in America. And when you're cruising around town in a Ford Fusion, you're cruising in style. And on the highway, you're getting 33 miles per gallon. Plus, Ford Fusion was ranked the most dependable among midsize cars by J.D. Power & Associates. So when's the best time to get a great deal? That's still right now.
Hurry into the final days of the Ford Best Place to Be sales event and get a Fusion with 0% financing for 60 months.
The Ford Best Place to Be sales event. It's still the best place to be.
For 99 cents?
Probably not.
Our 99-cent chicken flatbread sandwiches, now in two bold flavors, only at Taco Bell.
ABC's Modern Family, 1 hour season premiere, Wednesday, September 21st.
Auburn won it last year. Who will win it this year? The most sought-after trophy in college sports, the Coach's Trophy, presented by Dr. Pepper and DeAnthony Thomas. Checks into the game with Barner and James on that sideline, Herbie. They're going to go with the freshman here.
With the backs cramping with James and Barner. It's interesting. Let's see how he can do. He's been playing receiver. Now he's lined up in the backfield.
Gets his first carry from scrimmage and moved the pile pretty well out to the 11-yard line.
He's 165 pounds. A true freshman. Out of Los Angeles, many people thought he would go to USC. We got another man down. You know, that we're inside. You're thinking that the air conditioning's on. Air conditioning could be on to be comfortable conditions in here, but we've seen a lot of players here going down on both sides of the football.
Is this Adams?
That looks like Adams again. He was down earlier.
Let us take a break and go to the studio and Robert Flores for an update. Robert, what do you got for us?
All right, Brett, Boise State leading Georgia 21-7. They go 11 plays, 76 yards. Doug Martin goes in from 7 yards. Georgia quarterback Aaron Murray thus far just 90 yards through the air as Boise State leads 21-7. And South Carolina, after trailing 17-0 to East Carolina, they now lead 56-31. Stephen Garcia didn't get the start, but he certainly led the comeback.
Robert, thank you. You know, Herbie, let me tell you something. Boise gets out of Atlanta with a win tonight.
They're going to be favored.
They're going to take dead aim,
no question,
at playing in New Orleans for the BCS Championship. I'm telling you, they really become a BCS
buster. I mean, there's nobody. Somebody can beat them potentially, like Nevada did last year. But they're going to be favored in every game that they play the rest of the way.
Second and 5, and there's that inside handoff, short of the first down. And Edwards makes the stop for the Tigers.
Let's go back to Les Miles' formula to victory. It's field position, it's defense, it's special teams. This is a big third down for Oregon for field position.
Fumble, LSU football. Picked off by Eric Reed in the air. And Reed's at the 21. And LSU is in business.
And that is the risk that you take play a freshman, and you're forced to play a freshman in a football game. Sam Montgomery on the backside actually got his hand on the football, and DeAnthony Thomas needs to keep his head up because if James and Barner can't go, Chip Kelly's got to get him back up. Watch 99 off to the left. He gets a hand in there on the football, and Reed shows a pretty good athletic ability, catches it in midair, and makes the return. But LSU, this is the way they work. They force you into deep territory. They get a short field for their offense, and they either get a field goal here or they come up with a touchdown. But this is how Les Miles operates.
Learning how important it is to work in the weight room. First down and 10, and the Tigers are in business. Here is Ware, slips a tackle, spins forward on first down, and they're across the 20 into that red zone area right now. There's the youngster. He'll learn from this.
You know, Brent, Spencer Ware is a sophomore. I can remember him. Played high school football up in Cincinnati, Ohio, at Cincinnati Princeton, and was a quarterback, and he's turned into a pretty powerful running back down in Baton Rouge.
Toss play through the middle. First and goal for LSU Here's the young man who rushed for better than 100 yards in the Cotton Bowl in this building last January against Texas A&M. And they're coming right back with him.
LSU trying to get their own tempo going, and that offensive line sensing an opportunity here, starting to get a good push. And Will Blackwell, the right guard in the previous play, pulling around and just ripping through the Oregon defensive line. It's a pivotal point in the game with the Tigers up by three here midway through the third quarter.
Second and goal from the power. Again, testing the middle. That's three consecutive plays. Not a whole lot of imagination there, and the Ducks jumped it. And that makes it third and goal. Herbie, I'm a little bit surprised that they didn't get outside, try to get to the edge, try to do something out there a little bit.
Especially on early downs, but they've had some success pushing. Now let's remember, Oregon's committing 10 guys inside that box. You're leaving Reuben Randall isolated at the bottom of the screen, one-on-one against an Oregon corner.
Stay with the run, and Michael Ford, the sophomore, busts across. So LSU knew what they were doing. They figure they've got an advantage with that offensive line, and they kept pounding, and they came away with six.
That is old school football.
That's Michigan.
That is Michigan. James Stampley, the fullback.
That's Bo Schembechler.
That is.
Where did he learn that?
Let's flip it to Leroy Horde and follow him in there.
Drew Alamar on for the extra point. Tacks it on. And it's a 10-point LSU advantage. Biggest lead of the game, Irving.
Big third down and goal. And you're thinking maybe they try to go back to Reuben Randall outside. Look at the hole right away open up. Blackwell does a good job of getting a push to the outside. Gets Taylor Hart outside. And Stampley, that's a guy you want to follow. Stampley's about 245 pounds. And the combination right now of Spencer Ware and Michael Ford, very different what they offer to that backfield, but both showing some pretty good vision. And that time Ford cut it back and into the end zone. And now the Ducks are really reeling here, down 10.
And let's check it down below with Aaron.
Hey, and you guys mentioned it. De'Anthony Thomas really going to have to shake off that turnover there, because as of now, Kenyon Barner has left the field. He did tell a trainer he had cramps. Then they started working on his right ankle. They tried to tape it up, and then they had him leave the field, guys.
I wonder, Brent, if they can get an IV in him, anything, if it is cramping, to try to help him and LaMichael James both.
Herbie, I want to give tribute to the right side of that offensive line for LSU. Will Blackwell out of Monroe, Louisiana. Alex Hurst out of Bartlett, Tennessee. I mean, they blew a gaping hole on the right side down there. And, of course, Lonergan, courageous, staying in there and getting it done. De'Anthony Thomas and Mitchell are back deep. And this one with Thomas trying to get him some space, and he fumbles it again. LSU jumps on it.
A sophomore, Craig Lawson, who got in there and punched that ball. And you know, when you're in high school and you're as fast as De'Anthony Thomas, you can run by people all day. You get up to college football, and obviously you have to have the fundamentals of holding on to the football, because these LSU defenders,
LSU football,
wow, they're told to attack the football. Second straight time the freshman puts the ball on the ground. Not having Barner back there and not having LaMichael James really starting to catch up to Oregon. Watch six come in from behind right there and knock the ball loose.
The defensive front for Oregon better get ready. LSU's got a 10-point lead, and this is a perfect setup to go working on the clock from the power eye and see if your offensive line can wear them down. Here they come. The first running play, and it'll be Ware into the heart of that defense. This is where Oregon misses the fellas who were up front last year. Casey Matthews, I'll never forget that turnover he forced in the national championship game, and they rallied. But there are other fellas who are gone from a year ago. Rowe, Spencer,
Paysinger, yeah.
Paysinger. Those guys are really missed here tonight. You can say all you want about having a lot of guys who played games, we're going to be okay, but it ain't the same. And now it is second down and 7. On a play action, got it wide open. Peterson to the 7-yard line, and it is first down and goal. Beautiful call. Dialed up by LSU. They caught that front pressing.
That is a great call by Coach Studd on first and 10. Peterson's right here. Good job. He takes his time. He's patient. And how about the throw by Jarrett Lee? Right over the shoulder to Peterson. They get Pleasant out of position, and he almost took it into the end zone.
Herbie, that was the longest play of the game, 29 yards. First down and goal, where, again, nothing much doing here.
They have mixed up the play calling, and they've been able to, you know, they're sticking to their guns with their, if you want to call it stubbornness or whatever you might want to call it, but they have been able to control things these last couple drives, and I think they've mixed in enough of the play action. I think it's making it a little unsettling for the Oregon defense. That side of the football.
There's some Pac-12 coaches that are going to go to school on this tape. Sneaking right straight ahead is Jarrett Lee. In behind his big center, Lonergan, who came out the other end.
And Jarrett Lee taking exception to maybe some activity there after the tackle in the bottom of the pile. He came up. Had a few words for the Oregon defense.
Third down and goal. Remember, they stuck with the run the last time. Let's see what they do here. They go back into the gun. Ware is still the back. Three receivers to the right. Throw back to the left. One on one. Incomplete. Randall, and there's the flag. First and goal. They went back to him against the redshirt freshman, Terrence Mitchell, and it'll be first and goal.
That's the matchup that they want. And even though they had three receivers off to the right, and Jarrett Lee actually gave a little look off to the right.
Pass interference on a defense number 27. Foul is in the end zone. Ball will be placed at the 2-yard line. Automatic first down.
But he knew all along, Brent, he wanted to come. Look at him, look off to the right, and then come right back to the left because of the size advantage and because of the poor redshirt freshman going up against an experienced SEC receiver in Randall. He didn't have any chance.
Power eye, where dives over the top and just a little bit short of the end zone. Going to be marked inside the 1-yard line, and it'll be second down and goal here in the third quarter. Because of the problems off the field encountered by LSU, Oregon came into this game favored, which was a bit of a surprise when you consider how many folks are here from Baton Rouge. This is virtually a home game for LSU when you consider the crowd being involved in this game. Second down and goal. Toss play where? Got the lead block and the touchdown. There's your guy clearing the way again for you, Herbie.
Absolutely. And you talked about it a little earlier, Brent. Maybe go to the outside away from that Oregon defense where they're pinching down inside. And that time they did pop it outside. Stampley picked up a block. And guess who he took out? Terrence Mitchell, the redshirt freshman corner. And Spencer Ware squares those shoulders. He is a powerful runner. It's about 225 pounds.
Drew Alema. On another one.
Tight end outside, just trying to outflank them. They get a good block there. Good effort, actually, by the tight end, D'Angelo Peterson. He got a piece of two of the Oregon defenders. It's a beauty playing at Jerry's house, right?
Exactly. You watch that 60-yard big screen TV up
you
there.
You can't miss it.
There it is, the big screen up above. Not a bad seat in the house, folks, because you got the big screen. Oh, and the LSU fans are loving it.
Yeah.
They're hooping and hollering.
They're
not even in Baton Rouge. They're liking it up here tonight.
Absolutely.
So it's 30-13 with 3 minutes to go, and the LSU defense, he's mocking the duck, I think. He's down there doing the push-ups. And the offense tonight just hasn't got it done. Last year led the nation, 47 points a game. Tonight, 13, 530 yards a game. Tonight, 177. Rushing for 286, and tonight against another SEC defense, they've been held to 56 yards. Kirby, LSU put two touchdowns on the board in 320, and both came after those costly turnovers.
And a true freshman, DeAnthony Thomas, is out there. James is back out, this time with Josh Huff. They take the true freshman off the field.
Hang the kickoff high for Huff. He is stoned with a penalty flag down. There's a little bit of a ruckus going on at around the 30-yard line, and the penalty flag came flying.
During the return, holding receiving team number 4, 10-yard penalty, first down.
And let us go to Robert Flores in the studio. Robert.
All right, Brent, about 90 minutes from where you and Herbie are. Last night, Robert Griffin III helped Baylor beat a ranked team for just the fourth time since 1996. Griffin III highlighting the AT&T All-America Player of the Week update. 5 touchdowns. You can text VOTE to 55862 to take part and for a chance at a trip to the national championship.
All right, Robert, thank you very much. From the gun, incomplete, 2nd and 10. For the Oregon Ducks.
You know, that is 3 times that Oregon on kickoff returns has had penalties and put themselves in even a bigger hole to start their drives.
Thomas is deflected. 3rd down and 10, and they were all over him with that defense again. Mingo, your man, was coming off the edge.
Kiki Mingo, and if you can't tell at home, this stadium is rocking right now, and you feel like you're in Baton Rouge, and you got a couple Oregon Ducks out there playing on one leg, including the left tackle right now, Weems. But a good job and a good effort timing that by Benny Logan to knock that football down. How'd you like to call this play on 3rd and 10?
Mercy. Here they come. 99 in on him and incomplete. Sam Montgomery, Big Sam, at double 9, was closing in.
Yeah, they actually had James coming out of the backfield, and he was left untouched, but it was just the pressure. Forced the quarterback to throw off his back foot. Thomas didn't have anything on the ball, even though James was streaking down the right sideline on a wheel route.
2:46 left here in the third quarter. LSU 30, Oregon 13. And backed up is Jackson Rice. Here's Matthew. Over the other side of the 40. Got midfield. Down to the 48-yard line. The crowd tonight, 87,711. Enjoy this early season showdown. And our aerial coverage is provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned making tires for superior performance inspires what they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven. Jerry Jones, the owner of the Cowboys, in attendance tonight. But he appreciates a crowd of 87,000 coming here for a college game. 2.5 minutes. 4 on the right edge. Across the 25-yard line. Before Eddie Pleasant Gets him out of bounds.
Watch Peterson again. They're just outflanking the Oregon defense, getting outside. I'll tell you, Peterson's had a football game tonight for LSU. He's made a lot of catches, and we always get excited about that. But his blocking has been exceptional to spring these backs loose when they've had room to run. Kind of lining him up as an H, and he's getting a good job of seal blocks of pushing the Oregon defense to the inside.
They come back with Ford. Good balance. Michael Clay, the stop, and now it is Ford being substituted for, and Spencer Ware comes back into the game. Ware has rushed for 73 yards here tonight. Ford for 57. LSU, 210 yards of offense now, taking control here in the third quarter of this football game. And Spencer Ware close to another first down on second and eight. A very manageable third down coming up.
Just a really good cutback. He continues to show the vision. Both these backs, he and Michael Ford. And I think as this game goes on, remember, this is the first week of the season, but this offense, even with Jared Lee in there, all the questions, how would he do replacing Jordan Jefferson? They just seem to be getting more confident. Of course, the score could be a reflection of that, but there seems to be a little bit more continuity within the offense right now for the Tigers.
The tossed Ware, and he picks up the first down. Final minute of the third quarter. LSU takes control of this football game in this quarter.
You know, one thing that LSU is trying to do to try to avoid the cramps, they're rotating a lot of bodies in there. J.C. Copeland and James Stampley, the fullbacks, are rotating along with Spencer Ware and Michael Ford. Try to keep them fresh.
The freshman, Beckham, off to the left side of this formation. He's number 33. Coming back with Ford, who is tripped up, keeping the clock moving. They'll bring down the final seconds here in the third quarter. So LSU dominates the third quarter, forces a couple of turnovers on back-to-back plays, scores touchdowns off both of them. And now the Tigers are dominating the Ducks. This presentation of Saturday Night Football, presented by Southwest Airlines, will return after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Sweetheart.
Mom?
No, go up to your room, honey.
Contagion is gripping and powerful.
We need to know the scale of the epidemic.
They're moving the president underground. The year's most intense thriller.
In 72 hours, we'll know what it is. We're lucky.
Clearly, we're not lucky.
It's terrifying.
Get back in your car.
We're not sick.
A must-see.
It's mutated.
Contagion, rated PG-13, starts September 9th. Sober or get pulled over.
This is not a story about forgiveness.
Forgiveness.
Someone has to pay.
Someone has to pay. Someone has to pay.
They say vengeance is a dish best served cold. When everything you love has been stolen from you, someone has to pay.
Revenge premieres Wednesday, September 21st, 10, 9 central.
Someone has to pay.
Nissan's bottom line sales event has been extended. With better availability than Honda or Toyota, you save. Get an additional $500 holiday bonus cash on popular models like Altima, $179 plus bonus cash. Visit ChooseNissan.com. Test drive at your local Nissan dealer today. More cars, bonus cash, more savings. Hurry, and September 5th.
The
There's luxury that lulls. And there's luxury that thrills. Infiniti inspired performance. Visit the Infiniti Limited Engagement Summer Event. Our inventory selection is outstanding. The best offers of the season are now available. Lease an Infiniti G25 sedan for $319 per month or get 1.9% APR on all 2011 models.
Action News Sports, only on 6ABC.
We welcome you back to Arlington, Texas. We begin the fourth quarter here in a game that LSU took control of in the third quarter, turning two fumbles into two quick touchdowns. And now they're threatening again. It's across the 15 on a second down and seven. And it'll be third down as we take a look at the Pacific Life game summary. Overall, the Ducks have turned it over four times here tonight. Three critical fumbles. This one resulting in a touchdown as Matthew on a punt forced the fumble and scored. And then the freshman twice was turned over. First by Eric Reed and then again Herbie on the kickoff return.
Yeah, anytime you have four turnovers and it leads to 20 points and you have 10 penalties, odds are you're going to lose that football game.
Third and eight. Ford is the tailback. And the freshman wide receivers to the left. Jarrett Lee's going to try to go to him for his first touchdown. Knocked away in the corner of the end zone. And another fine play by Anthony Gildon, who has really held up on that corner.
That's the third time that, and he's cramping now too. That's the third time that Gildon has stepped up when he's been out there on an island and has been able to make a play. And it seems like a lot of times he's matched up against the freshman Beckham. There's no face guarding in college football, so Beckham wanted that call, but Gildon was in position that time to not give Beckham much of a chance to make the catch.
Drew Elema will attempt the field goal. Made one from 44. This 32 from the right hash, and he's knocked it in. 33-13. LSU leading favorite Oregon by 20.
Southwest makes the call.
What's the call?
I've got unnecessary bag fees.
Guys, I'm just driving.
Do I penalize for each bag fee?
I would.
$120 round trip and bag fees?
Man, that's a low blow.
Guys, I gotta get going here.
Hey, you want me to throw you off the tarmac?
Bags fly free. Southwest Airlines, it's the right call.
John Hancock, the future is yours. Visit FindTheAnswers.com.
You and I got a lot in common.
Really? You're tied to a chair, and I'm here with a gun in my hand.
I knew I'd find it.
He's like a father to you, right?
If you don't do this, he's a dead man.
Danny's gonna come back for me.
And when he does, he's your worst nightmare.
Now the gloves are off. All right, let's finish this.
What are you doing?
Let me get my watch back.
Killer Elite, rated R, starts September 23rd.
The 2012 M-Class continually monitors blind spots, scans the road to reveal potential threats, even helps awaken its driver if he begins to doze. So in the blink of an eye, it will have performed more active safety measures than most cars will in a lifetime. Introducing the all-new 2012 M-Class, quite possibly the most advanced SUV ever from Mercedes-Benz. The best or nothing.
Prepare yourself for the ultimate fantasy team.
Hello, angels.
ABC's Charlie's Angels, series premiere Thursday, September 22nd.
Which new coach, Al Golden of Miami or Randy Edsall at Maryland, will earn a win in their ACC debut? Well, you can find out. College football primetime, part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week, ESPN Monday, 8 Eastern time. So now LSU in complete control here with 14:07 remaining. Oregon looking for a spurt, trying to get something to build on back here. And James went back to return this kickoff. And he brings it out to about the 33-yard line. And now it is time for tonight's big picture, brought to you by Sony. And if you will watch it, you know that Auburn needed a near miracle today, and they got it. A huge onside kick, and they survive against a game Utah State team. Then perhaps the most impressive performance this side of LSU, Alabama, and what a showdown that'll be later this year in Tuscaloosa. And here's Andrew Luck.
Andrew Luck gets off to a good start. Kind of an efficient victory for Stanford.
Darren Thomas, and Matthew went for a pick six. It's second down, and he came within a whisker.
Well, he guessed at the right time and stepped right in front of that. He reads the route. It's DeAnthony Thomas, and that time Darren Thomas, the quarterback, catches a break. You're not going to see Matthew drop very many of those.
Second down and 10 for the beleaguered Ducks. Coming in underneath on that throw to Josh Huff.
You know, Brent, in that third quarter, Oregon didn't have a first down. They had 9 plays for 4 yards. Just a lot of that could be attributed to some confusion. LaMichael James out, Kenyon Barner out. And that's when the true freshman, Thomas, ended up fumbling the football twice, and then LSU able to capitalize on it.
See what they come up with here on third and 7. Dove back for the unofficial first down marker, stayed in bounds on the reach play, and it'll depend on they're going to move the chains. They're going to give him the first down. So good. The chains are moving across the way.
First down of this half. Pretty good effort there by Simon. And I thought Simon may have made the play, and I think these fans are reacting because they think he was about a yard short of the first down. Of course, they have the ability to look at this replay on the big screen here at the stadium.
And now some other folks may look at the replay. They're going on over to Les Miles' sideline to see if he wants to challenge this. You can challenge the spot.
Oh, yeah.
It was third and 6 from the 36. You got to get a big kick out of Les Miles.
The spot on the field.
No question. Remember, the yellow line is certainly unofficial.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he's out of bounds. No, he's not even close to
it. He's 2 or 3 yards out of bounds.
That wasn't even close.
Yeah. That angle's pretty easy to see. How about Simon? Mo Claiborne, Simon, Tyron Matthew, Eric Reed, Ron Brooks, Boston, Brandon Taylor. I mean, they've got 6 back there that could play about anywhere in the country. And they lost Patrick Peterson.
Yeah, let's not forget Patrick Peterson.
You'd think they'd take a step back after Patrick Peterson left. How about Matthew? He was a true freshman last year, wore 14. Patterson ends up leaving. Or Peterson ends up leaving, and Matthew decides to honor him by putting that number 7 on. Good call by Les Miles and the LSU fans here in the stadium. They were helping him make the call.
Speaking about instant replay, how about our buddy Jim Trussell getting a job with the Indianapolis Colts?
I saw that. Bill Polian.
Well, good for Trussell.
Absolutely.
I always thought that someday, Herbie, he could surface in the NFL. I really thought that sort of the system he ran at Ohio State, rather conservative, good on special teams, and maybe next year he'd become an assistant with somebody in the National Football League and see how it goes. It's nice to see him working
again. Yeah, absolutely. And it'd be interesting to see him in that capacity and how he'll be able to be very calculated and help out Peyton Manning and the Indianapolis Colts. But interesting, some of the games, we still got some games tomorrow. We've got a game Monday night on ESPN. So one of these weekends where we didn't have a ton of marquee matchups, but we did have some excitement. And at least now we're starting to see some of these teams for the first time, which is always good.
Best game of the weekend was Baylor-TCU.
Without a doubt. I mean, Robert Griffin's effort at TCU
to give them credit
to fight back.
Absolutely.
And I told Robert Griffin this morning on game day, I said, not just the way you guys made plays, but you guys were down late and answered to come down and hit that game-winning field goal to win it.
After review, the runner stepped out of bounds prior to gaining a first down at the 40-yard line. He will spot the ball at the 40-yard line. It will be fourth down and two. LSU will not be charged a timeout.
And Oregon's already broken the huddle, and they're ready. They're kind of anticipating that, and they're ready to go for it here on fourth down. What other choice do they have, right?
You got to set the they set the chains to reflect that it's fourth and two here. So they'll get the chains moved over in front of the LSU sideline.
Let's see what Chip Kelly decides to do. LSU is in straight up man-to-man, walked up on the line of scrimmage against the three receivers. A lot of times a speed option could be good here for Oregon.
Could be very close, but it looked like the Michael just kept on churning.
Now he got a good spot, favorable spot there.
That would give him a first down. There's the signal from Scott Novak, the referee. 12.5 minutes to go, and the Ducks trying to fight back here. They scored in bunches last year. Deep. Incomplete. Turned his receiver around on the throw. 2-and-a.
A lot of drops tonight. 2-and-a. Ball's behind him. If that ball's thrown in front of him, he's got a chance to run with it. But I know this is a lot of new personnel for Oregon, but Brent, remember, this is a team that averaged over 500 yards of offense last year and 47 points a game.
D'Anthony Thomas was a little bit confused about the play and almost came off. Second down and 10. The left tackle moved. That's Darian Weems, number 74, who pulled out.
Weems has been playing with a right ankle that looks like it's been bothering him. Thought they may have lost him for the game, but he's been taped up on that right ankle. You can see outside of his shoe and trying to give it an effort to be out there. But when you do that, you're trying to cheat a little bit and give yourself maybe a little bit of a head start against Sam Montgomery and the rest of the defensive linemen from LSU. Jumped a little early there.
Second and 15 in trouble, but he drops it off to LaMichael James. And James will do the rest. Got the first down for the Ducks.
That time, Weems did not get a quick head start, and they went right around him with Tyron Matthew. Now you got another offensive lineman, Carson York, who's an experienced player. Now he hobbles off for Oregon.
Thomas. Incomplete. It'll be second down and 10.
He wanted LaMichael James on a wheel route, and that play's been open for the Ducks, even though they've not been able to hit it. But Eric Reed, the safety, just was eyeing LaMichael James the whole time, took that throw away, and Darren Thomas tried to come back to the right. Just nobody open. LSU, great job with their coverage there.
D'Anthony Thomas back on the field for the Ducks on this second down. Drops in underneath. And 2-and-a short of the first down. One of the things LSU is doing tonight and doing very well, they're tackling in space, which they knew they had to do against Oregon.
Yeah, gang tackle and tackling in space. I don't care who you are when you take on this offense. That's the first thing you hear from defensive coaches. And LSU has certainly done that.
Third down and 4. Thomas going to scramble out and pick up the first down and get out of bounds on top of it. So overall, John Chavis has to be very pleased with what his defense has accomplished. Here's a man who is a defensive coordinator He was the coordinator of Tennessee when they won the first ever BCS championship. They beat Florida State. Chavis, graduate of Tennessee, played there, longtime assistant coach over there with Phil Fulmer. And now he is Les Miles' defensive coordinator. He always stresses funnel things to the linebackers, funnel them through. His linebackers are always, always excellent tacklers. First down and 10. Thomas comes in underneath, and there's DeAnthony. Thomas dances free. And DeAnthony, down by the 20-yard line. He's going to be thrilling to watch.
Well, all he has to do is, with his speed, is if he can shake one tackle. And you talked about getting into the weight room in the offseason. He'll be able to do that starting next year. But if he can shake one tackle, he's got the kind of speed where he's going to leave most defensive backs. And he accelerated upfield very quickly that time.
Got plenty of time left here for these Ducks. They can keep this fire burning. But Michael James is out there. Darren Thomas, DeAnthony Thomas. The offensive lines have a lot of holes that they're trying to fill here tonight. Rolling to the right. And close to a first down is Darren Thomas.
Kind of feeling some urgency. Obviously, when you get down by 20 points, I think a lot of people wondering, where's this urgency been from Darren Thomas and the Ducks?
A little bit and then kept going and appeared to have picked up the first down.
One thing you don't want to do against LSU is dance. I mean, you got to get upfield as best you can.
Carson York has come back in at right guard. They're substituting that right guard position. Everett Benyard has played in there. Remember, they had some costly penalties at that position. Grassu has really appeared to hold up at center with the rest of that offensive line here tonight for Oregon. So the Ducks now with a first and goal. Chance to score. Fake the end around. Darren throws for it. Got it. Touchdown, Oregon. Josh Huff is at the receiving end and a well-executed fake.
Yeah, and DeAnthony Thomas, I think, has done enough in this game to get some attention. You would think LaMichael James would get most of the attention, but here he comes in motion, and just a little bit of a play fake, enough misdirection, and then you roll out the other way, and it's a levels route. There's a guy short, a guy midway, and a guy downfield to the back of the end zone, and, of course, he finds his man for the touchdown that time in Huff.
So that was a spirited drive by the Ducks that time. And they pulled back to within 13. Still a lot of time left in Arlington.
The 2012 M-Class continually monitors blind spots, scans the road to reveal potential threats, even helps awaken its driver if he begins to doze. So in the blink of an eye, it will have performed more active safety measures than most cars will in a lifetime. Introducing the all-new 2012 M-Class, quite possibly the most advanced SUV ever from Mercedes-Benz. The best or nothing.
This is The Network, a network of possibilities. In here, pets never get lost. In here, every continent fits in one room.
That was fun. We're playing football outside.
Why are you sitting in the dark?
In here, you're never away from home. It's the AT&T network, and what's possible in here is almost impossible to say.
At Aviva, we wonder why other life insurance companies treat you like a policy, not a person. Instead of getting to know you, they simply assign you a number. Aviva is here to change all that. We're bringing humanity back to insurance and putting people before policies. Aviva Life Insurance and Annuities. We are building insurance around you.
One, two, three, hit me!
A jump start for your game, not your nerves. Proven push, stamina in a bottle. The original Gatorade.
Sometimes I feel so nice.
And thirst-quenching protein to help restore your body while cooling you down.
climb, perform, recover. The G-Series from Gatorade.
Saturday Night Football on ABC. Presented by Southwest Airlines. Find our fares online only at southwest.com. Mercedes-Benz. Experience truly great engineering today at your authorized dealer. And Gears of War 3. Stay tuned for the world premiere Gears of War 3 trailer.
LSU leading Oregon by 13 with 9:14 to go here in the house that Jerry built in Arlington, Texas. 87,000 plus. Beard kicks it off for the Ducks. And taking it for the end zone is Claiborne. Claiborne's got a gap. There's a penalty flag. Penalty flag is thrown on the return. And it's probably a block in the back or a shove here.
During the return, block in the back. Receiving team, number 57. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Well, we know that many of you are a little wet over there in Louisiana. We certainly hope that everybody is safe over there. This is Tropical Storm Lee, and expected to dump 10 to 15 inches of rain in a lot of places in Louisiana. And we certainly hope that your power is still on over there. But most important of all, we hope that all you folks in Louisiana are safe as that storm passes through. It is somewhat ironic that we've got Tropical Storm Lee, and here we've got a quarterback named Lee for LSU, Jarrett Lee, who tonight's 10 to 22 for 98 yards and the one touchdown. And he has the LSU Tigers ahead of the Oregon Ducks. And here is Ware battling toward the 15-yard line. As we go back to Jarrett Lee, who replaced the suspended Jordan Jefferson.
I look at those numbers, and you're not going to be impressed with the first three columns, but the last column, zero interceptions, hasn't made a lot of mistakes. For the style of offense that he's engineering, I think he's played pretty well, all things considered.
Second down and 8 for the Tigers. Through it. Had to make the catch. He was wide open and he stayed on his feet. But do we see a penalty flag back?
There's a flag in the backfield, which usually means holding, and I think it's going to be holding on LSU.
Half the distance to the goal. Second down.
We just talked about how is Jarrett Lee doing, and I love the play call here by Coach Studd, the offensive coordinator. Thinking about, oh, LSU's just going to try to pull it in, work some clock. And they decide to go with a double move and try to get him downfield and make a big play. But
got the hand up high on the shoulder pad.
That really stood out to me. Maybe there's something. You think it was because he came up a little bit high?
Because the hand was up high on the top of that pad. It didn't look good. And, didn't like, seem to be much of a case of holding. But it big for the Ducks. And Ford out to 10-yard line, because third down, if they can force a fourth down here, they can wind up with great field position again. But they have got to stop this LSU offense here. This is a big call. You wouldn't think so, leading by 13, but you don't want to give the Ducks great field position. Lonergan, the veteran, up over the ball. Ford is the running back. Beckham out to the right. And it is Ford on a cutback. And the Ducks have done just that. They have forced the punt now as Clay makes another stop for Oregon. He's their most active linebacker. And now we'll see. Barner has come onto the field to return this punt. Am I right or not? No, it's James. Let me check that. Yep. I looked down and thought for a moment that it was Barner who had come back after going to the locker room. But instead, here comes their Heisman Trophy candidate.
And Wing has been booming the ball tonight for LSU.
Well, here comes, you know, I knew that name, the Scottish Claymores, the late lamented European League. His daddy punted for him for a while.
Going back on me there.
There we go now. LaMichael. He's going to try to catch an edge. Thrown down with great coverage at the 35-yard line. So let's see what the Ducks can do here. Trailing by 13. You're watching Saturday Night Football on ABC.
The 2012 M-Class continually monitors blind spots, scans the road to reveal potential threats, even helps awaken its driver if he begins to doze. So in the blink of an eye, it will have performed more active safety measures than most cars will in a lifetime. Introducing the all-new 2012 M-Class, quite possibly the most advanced SUV ever from Mercedes-Benz. The best or nothing.
Is it really necessary to brew Coors Light down as low as 34 degrees? Does it really matter if every beer is filtered cold, aged cold, and packaged cold? Do the mountains really need to turn blue when your beer is as cold as the Rockies? Is Rocky Mountain Cold Refreshment really that important? You be the judge. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer.
For 99 cents?
Probably not.
Our 99-cent chicken flatbread sandwiches, now in two bold flavors, only at Taco Bell.
We're the next stage of human evolution.
We are the future.
Who's with me?
X-Men First Class.
Emily's just starting out, and on a budget. Like a ramen noodle every night budget. She thought Allstate car insurance was out of her reach until she heard about the value plan. Dollar for dollar, nobody protects you like Allstate.
ABC's Charlie's Angels premieres Thursday, September 22nd at 8, 7 Central.
Fans, stay tuned after the game for your late local news over most of these ABC stations and over on ESPN. Turn over to SportsCenter for post-game analysis as well as today's scores and highlights. And here we go. Big drive, Herbie, for the Ducks.
We were just talking. They're down 13 with 6.5 minutes to go. They're going to have to score here, try to hold on to those timeouts. But about the three-minute mark, if they can do that, they've got a shot here. This could be an interesting drive. See if they can score quick.
Need to avoid the silly penalties. 11 for 90 yards here tonight on first down. Darren Thomas, incomplete. Was a little bit short of Paulson, the tight end. And Matthew was looking again. What a dangerous defensive back he is.
Yeah, 5'9", 175 pounds, but is all over the field. He can line up at corner. They line him up at nickel over the slot receiver. They'll blitz him. Not only did he have a great Cotton Bowl last year against Texas A&M, as a true freshman, he was the playmaker, one of the key playmakers, even though Patrick Peterson got most of the attention last year.
Second down and 10. Now it is suddenly third and 10, and they don't want to be three and out at the six-minute mark, down 13.
I really don't understand the first two plays against this secondary, those long throws, you know, against these defensive backs and how quickly they break on the ball.
Simon has played well. Matthew has played nickel like he is right now. Claiborne on the other corner. They're coming back, and they're still well short of that first down. This is a fourth down. You're down by 13 points, and let's see what he dials up here. No indication that the punting team is coming out on the field. He knows he's got to get two scores here, so he's going for it.
Two and eight at the top, maybe on a crossing route. They had some success with that.
Incomplete. LSU football at the 40-yard line. And they can grind the clock now.
Well, those first two plays were such long throws, and they didn't have much of a chance at all being successful. And then on third down again, they went off to the right. You put LSU's defense in fourth down, they're going to pin their ears back. And they did a good job with coverage. That's more really a coverage downfield. But LSU's defense, as they've done for most of the night, steps up big again for the Tigers and Les Miles.
LSU led it only about 17-13 when those two fumbles hit in the third quarter, and the game hasn't been the same since. Oregon did score to make it a 13-point game, but now they turn it over on downs. And Jared Lee and his veteran offensive line will go to work on this clock. Here's the toss to Ware. Ware behind the right guard, Will Blackwell. Stay tuned for the Ford wrap-up after the game, and a reminder, fans, to log on to bcstailgate.com for your chance to win the ultimate tailgate F-150. So LSU is going to stay in the top five, Herbie. They're going to start to climb. They're going to be dreaming of a home game in the BCS Championship, but a lot of things ahead of them in that rugged SEC West. Don't forget, they've got to go to Tuscaloosa later in the year, but Les Miles has got himself a contender. No doubt about that. Second down and 9, and we're again first down against that tired defense down by the 25-yard line. And for Oregon, they're going to need to regroup now. Stanford has to take heart in what's happening here in the Pac-12 North. Sure. Everybody out there's got to feel a little bit better. I don't know what the Huskies are going to come up with this year up in Seattle. Sarkisian.
Yeah, and then Oregon fans are saying, let's not forget 2009 when they opened with a loss that year to Boise State on the road and regrouped a little bit and ended up winning that championship and getting to the Rose Bowl. So we'll see what happens with the Ducks. There's some talent on this team. They don't have the depth that you see at LSU, but they definitely have the talent.
The chant has begun. LSU. And then SEC.
That'll follow it.
And Ford, as we take a look at what LSU. And, of course, when you look ahead to games as Arkansas, Auburn will come up. They'll be better than they showed today. That's for sure. Got to go to Mississippi State. Listen, West Virginia is going to be no gimme on September 24th.
Yeah, I mean, and you're on the road at Alabama. I mean, the SEC, it's every week. I mean, once you get into conference play, even games that you think will be easy are going to be tough. You go to Tennessee, that's a tough game. You know, you go to Ole Miss, that's a tough game. So, but it's a football team with a great defense. Special teams again appear to be solid. The offense is going to get better each week. It'll be a fun team to watch this year.
Second down. Here's Ford spinning, battling for the first down, which he gets. The end is near. LSU is going to apparently win here today. You know, one other point we want to make. Jordan Jefferson hasn't been found guilty of anything yet. So everybody just hold on to that resolution.
Right. We'll kind of stay tuned, right?
Yeah, exactly.
But let's go back. All the talk about Jarrett Lee, how would he do? You know, they're not going to be able to have the same offense without Jordan Jefferson. His numbers aren't going to blow you away. 10 of 22 for 98 yards. But I think he's been very efficient. He's made a lot of checks at the line of scrimmage, try to get his team in the right play. And it's first week of the season. There aren't a lot of quarterbacks out there playing perfectly. But he'll learn from this, and he'll continue to get better for this offense.
And Ford breaks free at the 5. Touchdown. Michael Ford. Sophomore from Leesville, Louisiana, with a little frosting for the Tigers.
About this, the way this game has gone, to look back, and you've got Spencer Ware at 99 yards, and now Ford at 96 yards, both backs close to the century mark. And this is kind of, again, give Les Miles and Coach Studd, the offensive coordinator, a lot of credit sticking to their guns and kind of running their offensive game plan. And they got the breaks that they needed from the defense and special teams, and the offense eventually got going, but both backs close to 100 yards.
And suddenly, we've had 60 points scored. Unfortunately for Oregon, 40 of them by LSU.
Strangers Get your limited edition Xbox 360 console.
The 2012 M-Class continually monitors blind spots, scans the road to reveal potential threats, even helps awaken its driver if he begins to doze. So in the blink of an eye, it will have performed more active safety measures than most cars will in a lifetime. Introducing the all-new 2012 M-Class, quite possibly the most advanced SUV ever from Mercedes-Benz. The best or nothing.
Every day, millions of people choose to do the right thing. There's an insurance company that does that too. Liberty Mutual Insurance. Responsibility. What's your policy?
Oh, we've had a wonderful night in Arlington. Love coming here. These great blimp shots, aerial coverage provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned, making tires for superior performance, inspires when they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven. We'll see at Ann Arbor, Michigan's first night game next Saturday night. Remember, it's on ESPN rather than ABC. Irish hope to bounce back. Tough loss at the hands of South Florida. And Lou Holtz's son, Skip Holtz, today. Big win for Skip. And returning that is DeAnthony Thomas. Well, folks, the new season, and I promise you some controversy with this one now. Dancing with the Stars. Monday said, no, the Ducks not invited. September 19th, the most surprising cast ever, but it has a couple of your favorites. Soccer goalie Hope Solo.
Yeah, I'm pulling for Hope.
And LA Laker Ron Artest. I don't know what name he's going to use. We got a lot of people with changes.
I remember
on that
there was
show,
a day you know when saying? You never heard of Dancing with the Stars.
You touted me on it.
Now you're keeping me informed. You're keeping me dialed in.
I never missed it when Aaron Andrews was on it. We watched every week, my wife and I. Incomplete on the pass. But I'll tell you what a controversy has been. Spark, you know, I don't quite understand everything.
I don't either.
I wonder who's
Aaron's picking there. I'm picking Hope Solo. I'm gonna go with you.
We can rally with Hope.
Yeah.
She did a great job with the United States soccer team this summer. Finally lost the championship, but what a great performance. Darren Thomas here has the final 2.5 minutes coming up. Tune's been pretty active here tonight. Irby's kind of half dozen. Passes for the Ducks. He and the freshman Thomas. Thomas has caught 6 for 47 yards.
I think the plan was to use Tune. We talked about it all game. The freshman Thomas, Barner, Josh Huff, and LaMichael James all on the field together. But with the cramping in the third quarter, they had to get away from that. And that's when LSU really started to take the game over.
Hoffman. And so remember, we showed you that graphic about how difficult the Aflac trivia, how difficult it is to win a national championship after you lose your first one. But there's a Pac-12 conference championship this year. Ducks will still be favored in the North, I believe, Herbie. If they're not them, it's going to be Stanford. That's
yeah,
for sure.
You would think those two teams would be the favorite. Looks like Weems, the left tackle move. But let's talk a quick second about Oregon and the credibility that they are trying to achieve, not just on the West Coast, but nationally. And, you know, they earned a lot
Ball
of that last year.
On the offense, number 74, 5-yard penalty, first down.
They earned a lot of that last year by getting to the national championship. But after a loss like this on a big stage against another SEC power, there are a lot of fans around the country that are just going to say, you know, they're out of the Pac-12, no big deal. And you can see the end of the year is where it's going to get tough for them if they're going to try to make a run and get to a BCS bowl game.
Hats off to LaMichael James. You know, tough night, not taking the rest of it off, had some cramps, came back, returned punts, broke the career rushing record. And that's incomplete from Darren, intended for the freshman. So there are the stats tonight, 54 yards. And a touchdown. So both Auburn and now LSU, they have shut him down at the line of scrimmage, haven't they, Herbie?
Yes.
Here he is catching a pass in the middle of the field. Good receiver. Down to the 40-yard line.
I, I think if there's anything for the Pac-12 teams to learn, now you don't have a lot of defensive linemen in the Pac-12 the way you do with LSU and Auburn last year.
Exactly.
But you're going to have to try to commit to the line of scrimmage in the running game and take your chances with Darren Thomas in the passing attack. And it's not as if the Pac-12 hasn't tried that in the past, and Thomas has made them pay for it. But that's what they're going to try to do this year. It's not a reflection of Thomas. It's more about the receivers. Jeff Mayle's not lined up out there. So DeAnthony Thomas and Barner and Huff are going to have to really come on with their route running to help Thomas and James out in that backfield if Oregon's going to turn this thing around offensively and start to get it going. But they're not going to play another defense close to what they face tonight.
They did not. The Ducks now, we're talking about it. But let's watch Darren here on this second down. Is he going to pick it up? Yes, he is. This could be another first down. The clock will stop and a nifty little run. I just can't tell you how much I admire James, who just keeps on battling here with time running down and time running out. I want to go back to the defense. Only one turnover tonight, and it was just a blunder on the part of LSU. The quarterback was walking to call timeout, and the center snapped the ball past him, and the Ducks recovered that loose ball and kicked a field goal after that. But if you go back to that Auburn game, and again, they forced that fumble late, there were issues forced by that defense. You didn't have Cliff Harris tonight suspended. You didn't have that big interception. One of the big differences with Oregon tonight, they forced any turnovers.
Yeah, and again, you go back to the championship game, Darren Thomas, career high in pass attempts, was a national championship when he had 40 against Auburn, and he broke that tonight because he's had to throw the football tonight 52 times against another powerful SEC defense. It's going to be fun to watch LSU continue to move and grow. And Rex, the offensive coordinator, Coach Stud, really, I thought early in the game they were feeling their way, but let's give them credit. The numbers aren't crazy. 275 yards, only 98 yards passing. But when they sensed blood in the water, there he is again right in the middle. And Steve Kragthorpe off to the right.
Let's talk about Steve Kragthorpe. Yeah. He was the offensive coordinator and then struck with Parkinson's disease. And so now he's a quarterback coach. Young man from Missoula, Montana. And he has worked with Jarrett Lee. And it's just great to see him back on the field. And
sure,
Coach Stud moves in there on the left-hand side. He's a veteran offensive line coach, and they did a good job up there tonight.
Yeah, they did. And Steve has done so much, you're right, for Jarrett Lee and Jordan Jefferson. But Stud called plays when he was at Bowling Green after Urban Meyer left to go to Utah.
So it's a first down and goal inside the five-yard line. There's David Paulson. So the Ducks trying to get another touchdown here in the final 22 seconds of the ball game. And it's the freshman's first touchdown. DeAnthony Thomas, number 6. And what a career he figures to have up in Eugene. Out of Crenshaw High School, there was a verbal commitment to USC. But in the end, when he went up to Eugene, he liked the community. He liked the coaches. He liked the teammates. And he committed to Oregon. And you can just see the future. When he gets stronger, he won't be fumbling the ball like that. They won't be knocking it out of his hands because he'll just get stronger and it'll become a much stronger grip on the football. As well as unfortunate things, but now he has his first touchdown. And I know you're pleased for the
young. Yeah, and not only that, the drive. The drive doesn't mean anything in this game, but you're down, the game's over, and it's easy to just shut it down and just say, you know what, it doesn't really matter. What's the big deal if we score or not? But when you're at the first game of the season, a head coach is looking for more than just execution. A head coach is looking at heart. Who's going to compete? Even though this game is over, who wants to continue to compete? And that time, the offense competed down the field.
So I see Oklahoma and Alabama staying there 1-2. And what, LSU would climb to 3 and Boise State and Florida State by. Well, you tell me. You're a voter.
Yeah. Well, I think that you're definitely going to see LSU move up, probably up to 3. Boise State, if they are able to hold on and secure a victory against Georgia, they're going to be in there 4. And you said it earlier, we've been talking about a lot in the preseason. If Boise State got by Georgia, they're going to be favored the rest of the year. It's going to be the big issue is going to be if they run the table, they'll be favored in every game. And an Alabama and an Oklahoma and an LSU eventually lose down the road. Undefeated Boise, we get into this debate every year.
They won. This final just came through.
It's over. Yeah. Then, you know, but undefeated Boise down the road, they're going to be that team once again that everybody's going to be kind of wondering, could they potentially create the controversy for the BCS?
Indeed, they could be the ultimate BCS buster.
Yep.
Because they got, you know, they
Kellen
got, they're up high now. They set sail. Kellen Moore, another outstanding young quarterback.
I think he had four incompletions tonight.
So the onside kick, and the one thing that Utah State will practice is go after an onside kick. Don't wait for it to come to you. And Randall did just that for LSU. And that'll do it. The Tigers prevail here. We got 12 seconds left as they bring the offense out for one final snap. They'll give us a victory formation. And the hat has done it again. That's that peak and that cap that Les Miles wears. That's why he got that nickname. When you take a look at his record, folks, one word can describe him: underrated. I know we make fun of some time management problems and things, chewing grass on the sideline, but Les Miles does a heck of a job of coaching. And he did again here, getting this team ready after that distraction. Chip Kelly over there. Shake hands. Well, Les.
We're walking.
LSU Network ready to go to work. Tyron Matthew with that big forced fumble on the punt. And let's check in with Aaron Andrews and Coach Les Miles.
I don't have to tell you what you've been through, but you told us an exhausting couple of weeks with everything that went on off the field with your team. You play your backup as the starter tonight in a national championship setting. How do you put this into words?
Our football team's united. They play together. If you put a ball on the line, they'll scrap you for it. It's a great group of guys.
You told me before the game you wanted Jarrett Lee just to have fun, stay calm. When did you notice he was doing that?
Well, I think he did the things that we needed to do to win, and he made some. It's all a progress, you know, all a process that he'll have to go through, but he can play better than he did today.
And then the defense really did some things that you like. What was the key in finally getting through to Oregon's tempo?
Well, to me, we played with an intensity that started the first play and ended the last play. And I challenged them, as did our defensive staff. John Chavis did a great job. But we asked them to be ready. And ready was a big word. And, you know, they ran a tempo offense, and it's a fast pace. And it's, well, the reality is we were ready.
You certainly were. Coach, thanks so much. And Jarrett, you've been through so much these past couple weeks and also in your career here at LSU. Put tonight in words.
Yeah, it was just, you know, it was a great win for us. We just we knew we had a lot on our a lot on our minds coming into this game, but we knew we just had to stay focused. And we played hard tonight. We ran the ball well, we threw the ball well, and we just stayed focused. They're a great football team, give credit to them, but you know, we just played hard and got the W.
Appreciate it. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Well, Aaron, thank you very much. And Herbie, your final thought on this win by LSU?
Well, it's been a long time since we saw two top five teams play in the opening weekend. There's a lot at stake here, of course, with the BCS. That's the way it's set up. And LSU prevailed. Their defense dominated the football game. And there was a battle once again at the line of scrimmage. And Jarrett Lee, I thought Les Miles put it perfectly. He did what he had to do. He managed the game, made smart decisions, and avoided the big mistakes and put themselves in a position to be able to win. But you'll always look back at that third quarter where LSU took advantage and got after the true freshman, DeAnthony Thomas, and forced those two turnovers.
Congratulations to both schools for playing a game like this to start the season with so much on the line. LSU beats Oregon 40-27. Next Saturday on College Football Primetime, ESPN at 8 Eastern. We'll go to Ann Arbor. Michigan takes on Notre Dame. First night game ever in the Big House. Won't that be something? Thanks for watching ESPN on ABC. Now, we're going to take you to the studio for the Ford wrap-up, and here's Robert Flores. Take it away, Robert.